He's tea. He's man. He's the tea man.
On Seattle's number one hit music station, Cube 93.
The T-Man Show.
Oh, yeah.
1-866-663-T-Man.
All right, once we heard about this Tijuana thing, we knew we were in trouble. T-Man is off again today after his week-long party now at the Super Bowl, but we'll be back tomorrow morning. Now more of the best of T-Man.
Pop princess Jessica Simpson married her pop prince this weekend. Jessica tied the knot with Nick Lachey of 98 Degrees at a lavish ceremony outside of Austin, Texas.
When did this happen?
Didn't you hear him? He said this past weekend, lavish ceremony outside of Texas.
When did this happen?
Jessica tied the knot with Nick Lachey of 98 Degrees at a lavish ceremony outside of Austin, Texas.
When did this happen?
One of us was supposed to marry her, I thought. What the hell?
That's what you're supposed to say when you're just completely confused by her actions, even though you know exactly when it happened.
Right. Okay.
How does she do that? Was she not lying when she said she was a virgin and was going to wait to her wedding day with this 98-degree, washed-up, 19-year-old hack?
Not 19, he's 28, by the way.
He's what?
28.
28?
Yes.
Wow.
When did this happen?
She's too old for him.
She's unbelievable. 22.
She's 22 now?
Yes.
Yeah, I saw her in the club in L.A. when she was like 20, 19, whatever it was.
Right?
Mm. Yes.
Okay.
We had a pact. If neither of us was married by 40, we'd get married.
Oh, yeah.
Well, at least I had the pact.
Right. In your head, right?
And now she's married, huh?
She is.
When?
Her and Nick Lachey.
Nick Lachey. Why not marry just a... Go to a mission center and pick out the first guy you like.
Yeah. He's a handsome man.
Fine, but he's worthless.
Oh, now.
Why marry a guy that's worthless, Terry?
He's a singer. He can relate to her.
Right.
He's more like 50 degrees now.
He's a singer. Like, everyone going to the karaoke bars tonight is a singer. That's how much of a singer he is from this point forward. Has 98 Degrees got anything going on? Can someone correct me here? Does anyone know of an album coming out? Are they working on anything? Do they have any prospects? Have they signed any contracts? Do they still have a deal with a record label? Yes or no? Anyone?
I assume they still have a deal, but I don't know.
Who? Well, look it up, Steven.
I am.
Go on 98degrees.com.
Jessica tied the knot with Nick Lachey of 98 Degrees at a lavish ceremony outside of Austin, Texas. The newlyweds first met in 1999.
Yes. Nick Lachey's career went downhill. 99.
Uh-huh.
It started in 99.
And ended.
In 99.
Well, it was a 98 Degrees board game. Do you want that?
No, of course. Yeah, print that out.
Okay.
They already have a greatest hit seat.
Oh,
geez. 98 Degrees collection.
Jimmy Fred Wayman. What's that now? They took their one album and they just mixed up the rotation and put out a greatest hits album, huh?
Well, the collection would make you think it is like a greatest hits type CD.
Right. Why, what does it say? The best of?
It just says the collection.
The collection.
It says hits from the past 5 years, as well as an 8-minute video compilation.
Jeez.
Last 5 years.
When did this happen? 98 Degrees.
Wow.
Do they have anything coming up?
Not to my knowledge.
All right.
What about her? What's her big hit right
now?
That must be true love for them.
Must be.
She was on that 70s show, or she's going to be on it. I've seen her.
As a regular?
No, a couple episodes.
All right.
But she's in a bikini in it, though.
When did this happen? Okay. Well, I'm not happy with this.
Well, you can't really do much about it, so...
Well, that's what you say.
Oh, jeez.
Fine.
You're going to give her a call. What did you do?
What if I could?
Yeah, right.
What did you find out there, Stephen? Do they have a website?
They do, yeah. 98degrees.com.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I was joking.
Boy, they've got keychains, all kinds of things.
Is that right?
There. Yes. Mm-hmm. Like
course.
Crazy.
So do new kids, Terry.
Well, I know.
Is that right?
There's photos of the boys at SeaWorld. Swimming with Shamu.
Jeez. With Shamu?
I don't know if it's officially Shamu, but...
Well, if they add him to the band, maybe they got something going there. Does it talk about any upcoming tour dates or anything as far as albums or what?
I'm trying to find that out.
Because even if they're touring, that's a good sign.
Yes.
But I don't think they are. I don't think there's any market for them. You hear 98 Degrees coming with... Unless it's with something major, you're not remotely interested.
Mm-hmm.
They couldn't sell out a phone booth.
Nice.
So, what does it say? Besides visiting Shamu.
There are no events scheduled at this time. Under schedule is what it says.
Or later.
Right. We'll do our best to keep you informed.
We don't plan on any events being scheduled for the next 3 centuries.
Right.
Yes, Jimmy Fred.
Yes, the last posting from Drew of 98 Degrees
right.
was on February 28th, and it says, "It's news to me. I just want to apologize to you all. We have not broken up. I hope that will clear things up. We are, however, taking a break, like I said before."
Taking a break.
Taking a break.
Yes. Yeah.
Getting married and having kids.
And that was in February.
Yes.
We haven't heard anything since February.
No.
We're in a nice late period of October.
Right.
He hasn't posted anything since.
Thanks, Drew.
Yeah. We're happy to know they're not broken up, though.
Yes.
Jeez. Be nice to take a year break, huh?
Okay.
Next thing you know, they're gonna come out with a big old album. And,
wow. Yeah, he's making taxpayer records right now.
Right.
When did they get married? Over the weekend?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. They sure did.
That just doesn't seem right.
Austin,
so what's
Texas.
The over-under? What's the over-under before they pull each other's hair out?
6 years.
6 years?
Yes.
Yeah.
No way. 6 months.
Oh, jeez.
I'll give him 3 years.
You'll give him three?
Because she's that devout religious woman who's going to try hard.
Mm-hmm.
That lasts 3 years.
Okay.
He's only marrying her for a little action?
No, he just knows he's on a major spiral, rapid, accelerated pace downhill. And, yeah, marry her now. While she still thinks you have a shot at something. Women don't tolerate that. Women will not tolerate a guy who... It's unfortunate, however, but it's true that women won't tolerate a guy who has no prospects. Oh. You could be the most devoted type. The women find that very unattractive.
Well...
In all walks of life.
Yeah.
Give me any geographic location. Give me any class of society.
Mm-hmm.
Women get turned off by men who are schlubs.
Well, yeah, of course, yes.
But he's so hot.
No, that doesn't last.
That, yeah, it only goes so far.
So what's his aspirations? By the end of the year, I'll be a Backstreet Boy. I promise.
Well, maybe he'll go into acting or be
right.
a star. Mr. Action, you know?
Okay.
The next action star.
What do you have there? What else?
Got some news about Chelsea Clinton, according to the London Daily Mirror.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she wants to move into an off-campus apartment in out of Oxford and with her boyfriend,
wow.
Ian Klaus. Ooh.
Chip off the old block, huh?
But Bill says, oh, no, I don't think that's
right.
going to happen.
He's the kind of father who would.
Yeah.
Kind of father who gets so much ass. Kind of father who's such a sexual deviant. He'd be the type to be overprotective on his daughter.
Yeah, he's not going to let it
that's
happen.
That's the way psychology works. That's the kind of father who's going to put his foot down strongly. As opposed to, he's supposed to be this liberal politician.
Right.
If he's so liberal, let your daughter move in with her boyfriend. Take it 17 times a week.
Oh, boy. Nice.
If he wants to put his fist in there, he's allowed, because they're living together.
Wow.
They're living together.
Right.
Rules change.
That's right.
Okay.
It's rule number one on the living together rule list.
I do accept the fist.
Right.
Whenever.
If I decide I want to give you the fist, you take the fist.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
I'll live by myself.
So Bill Clinton is having a cow, basically, right?
Yeah, he's saying it won't happen. And, in fact, he and his security advisors won't even think about it.
He has the Secret Service staking out the potential residents.
Right.
Make sure there's no living together going on.
Yeah.
Unbelievable hypocrisy of the world.
According to...
He has interns as old as her under his desk. But she's not allowed to live with her boyfriend, who she's been with now for about 2 years,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, something like that for a while, yeah.
2-3 years.
Mm-hmm. They look very happy.
And I'm not saying necessarily that as a father he's wrong, but he's the last father who should be so vehement in expressing his feelings.
She's the one looking at him like, what are you talking about,
right.
Dad? Are you serious?
I learned everything I got in me from your dumbass.
Right.
Although I thought he was a great president.
Yeah, you did. But I guess...
90s were a great decade.
Yeah. In the dorms, you can't have visitors past midnight.
Right.
So...
Midnight in Chelsea.
Yeah. It's one of the reasons they want to move out.
Is that a song, or did I just make that up?
It is a song.
Yes.
Bon Jovi, I think.
Wow.
Ooh.
I love Bon Jovi. When did this happen?
Okay.
What's that now?
Who doesn't love Bon Jovi?
I would be hard-pressed to find someone.
The T-Man.
Don't ever take sides with anyone. Against the family again. Ever.
The T-Man Show.
Show.
Hey, have things gotten so bad you'd trade your husband in for Fred Wieman? Then call us now. 1-866-663-TMAN.
Terry, what do you have on your pile this morning? What's happening? We have, you know who's coming down this morning?
Who?
Just called us. He's on his way down. Is he a top 10? I guess he is. He's a top 10 dysfunctional family member, Terry.
All right.
Come down whenever he damn pleases.
Yes.
He's the real Amo of
him. Oh, good. We haven't seen him in a while.
Well, we don't see him much when he's here because we always send him out on missions.
And he's very good at those missions.
Yes.
I like that.
And what little things are on your calendar this morning, Stephen, that we could do with the real mofo? Could you look into that while Terry gives us a couple of ditties here?
I sure can.
Okay.
Well, I was going to tell you about Justin Timberlake and how he has admitted to smoking a blunt with Nelly. He did an interview with
Safe, Terry? Who can steer clear?
Obviously no one now.
If the driven, what is the expression about the driven snow? The pure as the driven snow.
You're asking me? You're gonna be like
Hot Shot would be the authority on this.
Like, what?
If the pure as the driven snow, Justin Timberlake, can't steer clear of the cigar that's a little funky, then how can anyone? He admitted to this to
who? Yes, he did it. He admitted it in an interview with For Him magazine.
Oh, jeez. All right, someone's got to pull him aside. So you're supposed to shut your mouth on these things, dude. Yeah,
really. He said it happened when they finished recording the song "Girlfriend" together.
Girlfriend.
They got done doing it and decided to, you know, light one up.
And it was a good time had by all, I trust.
Guess so.
Does Nelly have some good?
I would assume.
Wow.
I would just assume he does.
Does he hide it under that Band-Aid, Terry?
Probably. Oh, we're done?
Yes.
Light it up.
Another lame white dude trying to fit in with cool kids.
I guess so.
Plenty of those out there.
Yes. Justin's starting to sense that maybe he doesn't fit in as much as he wants to.
Yeah, he's just trying
So he's overcompensating in a poor fashion, youngsters.
Not a good role model.
Right.
Don't succumb to the pressure.
Absolutely not.
It does make you cooler, but don't succumb to the pressure.
Justin Timberlake is the devil.
Oh, my God.
So,
Wow.
Brittany's starting to think, oh, he's going crazy without me.
See.
Yeah. Pass me that blunt. Thank you. Yeah. Very nice. Terrific.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
He's trying hard.
Horrible. Fascinating. Beautiful. Terrible. All those things rolled up into one. Makes a blunt. What else? What else you got there?
So, next year you'll be able to watch figure skating 24 hours a day because the Ice Channel, it will debut.
The Ice Channel?
The Ice Channel, yes.
Who's smoking a blunt there?
I don't know. Right. It's a channel that
what is television?
All its programming to ice skating.
It would devote all its programming to ice skating.
Yes.
What has become of television, Terry? Is it like a magazine stand now that there is? And that's not a stretch.
No.
Television is now in such a state that there is a channel for every specialty type situation that you may call a hobby or a. There's a woodcrafting channel,
there's
somewhere out there.
There's
a quilting channel. There's stock racing channels where all they do is have stock car racing all the time. Makes me wonder why I have to sit and watch it on ESPN still.
Yes, they do.
Unbelievable. And this is an ice skating channel. How can you show 24 hours a day, 7 day a week ice skating?
Well,
how do you do that?
Is
there enough ice skating going on out there? And here's a 4-year-old that we think looks very promising.
Right. Probably have the Dorothy Hamill show.
Right, right.
She welcomes people to the show.
Okay, that's 1 hour for one day a week.
Show stuff from the Olympics, maybe?
Do you show reruns as Queer as Folk on that channel? Yeah. What do you do on the ice skating channel to fill time, Terry?
Well, you know, you talk to all your old champions and relive all, I don't know.
All of a sudden, Brian Boitano's
guest
star on Queer as Folk.
There you go. Show some ice capades.
I just don't know.
Things like that.
Mm-hmm.
Disney on ice.
Monday through Friday's Nancy Kerrigan days.
Right.
Wow.
Maybe Tanya
might be
fun. Could get a job.
Maybe we were a year early on our live show from the ice skating rink. Maybe the Ice Channel would have been all over it to broadcast live.
They'd be looking for stuff.
As Tanya did her routine.
Yes.
That she cried at during the Olympics.
Right, right.
Yes.
You T-Man, made her cry there, too, didn't you?
The T-Man Ice... Yeah, she cried a couple of times that morning. The T-Man Ice Capades... Perhaps we'll be offered to the Ice Channel if we are so generous.
Yes.
The Ice Channel? Are you kidding me?
Ice Channel, 24 hours a day.
Is it going to be a solitaire channel soon?
Probably.
Where does it end? good.
I don't know.
My mom will watch it.
You
my mom loves
yeah,
it.
Yeah, your mom will watch it. Be like, Black 7 on the Red 6.
Oh, you screwed up. You made the wrong move.
All it is, people sitting around playing solitaire. Is there a chess channel?
Coming soon.
Ah. Craziness.
I knew a woman who used to fly to like 10 or 12 ice skating competitions a month or a year. Oh, so she loved it.
Wow.
She'll be into it. There's people that are that freaky.
And we'll sit there watching all day long.
I guess.
Dinner! No! They're about to do another triple axel!
TiVo guy puts ice skates on.
Yes. Start skating around your TV. Something special is happening on channel 9203. Yeah. Well, I can't wait, Terry.
I know.
Yes.
I'm so excited.
Mm-hmm.
Probably just another channel we'll be forced to pay for. That's cable subscribers. Yeah.
We put it in basic cable. We had a jack up your rates, $2.99.
Right.
You're on the air. Hello.
Hello?
Yes.
Good morning, T-Man.
How are you, sir?
Are
you pinching yourself this morning, realizing that the Ice Channel is coming your way in less than a year?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay. Because I'm doing that right now. I'm pinching myself, sir.
I got a small problem. I just got out of a 7-year relationship.
Mm-hmm. You sound like you're staggering. Are you okay there? Mm. Is it the blow dealt to you after 7 years of being with someone? Now you're on your own, or are you just kind of a little loopy this morning? In general.
No, I just woke up. Tired.
Mm-hmm. All right, so...
And I guess you can say low down, too, after 7 years, that is a long time.
Well, you can't be that down when knowing that the Ice Channel's coming. It's got to balance you out to some degree. 7 years, you were married or just involved?
No, just involved.
You were living with this woman?
Yeah.
Wow.
And what caused the termination of this little situation you had there? Was there an isolated incident or just a series of events?
I guess you can say a series of events.
But if there was a straw that broke the camel's back, what was it?
She wanted to go out and...
Screw other guys.
Oh. Not really screw around. She just...
She wanted to go out and party and just not with you.
With her friends and whatnot. And
right.
She didn't feel that she could do that.
So she broke up with you. There's no denying, and you're going to be man enough to admit, because most people, when they have a breakup situation... If it's not them that was the deciding factor in the breakup, they still say to other people it is. It was. It was a mutual thing, means he broke up with me. Or
right.
Yeah. So, but you're feeling confident enough in this tough state to at least admit you were broken up with.
All right, she broke up with me. I mean...
Did it shock you or you saw it coming?
I sort of saw it coming.
What, you got a seven-second delay over there?
I tried not to look.
You tried not to look, but so you weren't seeing the signs that were clearly in front of your face.
Well, I was, but I was ignoring
you
them.
Were just
I was hoping
denial.
It'd
yes.
go away that...
Very normal.
And
you're being very honest and candid with us, which makes you a much more desirable candidate, I would imagine, to other women who are listening to this right now.
Yeah, because they're going, oh, he's so sensitive.
Right. Mm-hmm. And he's devastated, and I'll be there to pick up the pieces and screw him over twice as big.
No.
7 years you were devoted to this woman, and you were completely faithful and all that good stuff, or no?
No, I was. I'd look, but
damn
that's
fool.
As far as it goes.
Now,
mm-hmm.
That's good.
You would look around and notice when there was a hot-ass woman near you, but that would be the end of it.
Yeah, but what guy
don't you wish you acted on that now, huh?
What guy did you ever look around?
Did you ever have opportunities? Yeah, all guys look around, but did you ever have an opportunity where you know you could have screwed somebody else and you turned it down because you were committed?
Plenty of times.
Wow. So a lot of women made it clear to you that they wanted you over the 7-year period, and you said no.
Yeah.
Now, do we believe him on this or no?
Yes, I do.
You do?
I just...
Because you want to believe him, Terry.
I just think that he sounds... I mean, for him to be so honest with everything...
It's a turn-on to women.
Well, I think that a lot of...
Women want to screw honesty.
Well, I think they say, you know, there's one of the good guys who unfortunately got screwed over, but it doesn't sound like he's bitter or anything like that.
Well, you don't know, Terry. He could have a handgun, who knows, in his hand right now. You're not like that, I hope, right?
No.
Okay, you are completely miserable inside, but you're not going to be the type that looks for revenge or anything like that. You're moving on.
I'm trying to move on, and I don't know if miserable inside explains. It's more like...
Miserable inside is normal, but you're not going to be the type that is completely dwelling on your past relationship with her. You're looking forward. Is that fair to say or no?
Yeah.
You're not going to keep calling her and stuff like that. You recognize that she's made it clear it's over.
Yeah, if she decides to call me and wants back, then...
Then that's one thing, but you're not going to make any effort to bother her since she's made it clear she's moving on.
No.
Wow. This sounds too good to be true with a breakup, Terry. This doesn't happen this way anymore these days.
Right. But then again, after 7 years, maybe they have that communication, which is so important.
You're not writing her letters? You're not calling her at work, listening to her pick up and hang up, or what?
Nope.
None of that. Man, that's at least acceptable. You're allowed to call once her at work, have her say hello, listen to her say hello, and then hang up. You're not going to take that option?
Nope.
Okay, good.
She told me that she didn't want to talk to me or nothing. So.
Can I call her at work, listen to her say hello, and hang up?
No,
because I think I miss her more than you. Wow.
I think it's safe to say this is not a sad sack Troy situation.
But he sounds like a sad sack Troy, but all the things he's saying are indicating that he's not.
Right.
He's sad, which is very understandable, but he's dealing with it in as healthy a way
as can be
asked of a person.
Right. Very mature.
And now you're looking for the next move in your life.
Well, after 7 years, I don't know how to go out and date. I don't.
What are the chances she's in the trunk of his car right now?
Not good.
Okay,
no,
good.
No.
You just don't know how to date. You don't know how to get started.
Yeah, I've been out of it for so long.
It's much harder, too, I would assume, for a man, don't you think?
I speak for all women while representing all men, sir, so I'm glad you called. And the women instincts that I have really want you to describe yourself right now to them. It's very important that you either paint a picture of yourself and do your best to airbrush the bad parts.
Right.
6 foot, brown hair, brown eyes, 160.
Huh? A little on the lean side, huh, there, sir? Do you work out at all? Are you athletic?
She was a terrible cook.
For most part. I stay in shape.
Oh, go ahead.
I'm not as athletic as I could be or
right?
should be.
What do you do there, sir? What occupies your days?
I'm a truck driver.
Huh.
There you go.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
A distraught truck driver.
Watch out.
Just doesn't seem to make much sense, does it?
No, but sounds like it's...
And you work Monday to Friday or what?
Yep.
And where do you haul your load to?
Yeah, you're a long hauler or just pretty much short?
I'm local. The first place I go is Portland and Bellingham.
You in a union or no?
No.
Huh? You work on your own?
No, I work for company, Haney.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, nothing beats a great pair of legs.
Yeah.
That's different.
Haynes.
Okay, right. Well, hey.
See, he sounds like a really good catch because it sounds like he's, you know, he can take things and say, all right.
But how did some woman out there get sick of him, Terry? How'd that happen?
Maybe she looked at it, you know, after 7 years and thought maybe he doesn't have... For her,
what she needs,
yes,
enough excitement,
right? Maybe they just got too settled in.
A wedge. Oh. This is what is your name, sir?
Jay
Song.
Oh.
All right, this song doesn't fit.
Yeah,
come on.
What's up, Hasha?
Hasha looked very hard for that one,
and you didn't like
right?
it,
right? Jay, you have anything planned, Jay?
Say it again?
Do you have anything planned for the next week, 2 weeks, a month? Do you have a little social game plan?
Working and going to school.
Huh?
Hopefully.
Now, I'll tell you this. This man is saying all the right things. He doesn't sound like he's bullcrapping.
No.
But I will add this. Usually in circumstances like this, women are listening. They hear what's going on. They hear a man who's become very available, who sounds really on the level, an honest guy, who's should be very appealing. And yet my phone lines are filled with guys. Women are calling. It's very troubling to me that women are hearing this right now, and no women are calling to make it make themselves known to Jay that they would love to be in his company.
They
so
like
he's
the
not
bad
turning
boys.
Them on. I guess.
See, I know. I disagree with you on that.
Well, I'm telling you.
I know.
Disagree.
No, but I'm saying.
You think
I'm
all
sure
these guys
that,
are really women?
No. I'm sure that guys are the first ones to call. But I think that there's quite a few women out there who listen to him and say, wow, you know, he sounds like a really good guy, solid man, so on and so forth. But the guys are calling up going, yeah, he's a big pussy. Come on, go out there, start using women, whatever. Strike back, all that crap.
The weird part is Terry's so prepared to talk over a song like this.
Well. Okay, that's not easy.
So.
Yes.
I just think that men are quick on the draw when it comes to this type of situation.
Well, let's go to the phone lines that are filled, and every one right now. I got to get rid of some of these guys to perhaps make available a line to a woman who hears Jay and feels for Jay and wants Jay, Terry. But as Steven mentioned subtly in the past couple of minutes, maybe he's not bad boy enough. Maybe he's not a turn-on. Maybe he just sounds like too much of a pushover. Maybe he just sounds very appealing. You're on the air. Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
Hey, I just got through a divorce after 7 years.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good job.
They call it the 7 year itch.
The 7 year itch.
All these women getting the 7 year itch on you guys?
They must be.
I think it's usually the men that do that.
And you, like Jay, were pretty much in a situation that you can't call the shots because she's telling you she's moving on and there's nothing you can do about it.
No, pretty much the reverse.
Oh, you moved on.
Yeah.
All right. That makes Jay feel better.
Yeah.
Sorry, Jay.
That's good.
But if you guys want to go out.
Yeah. Okay, this line started ringing yet again. Let's see who's on it. You're on the air. Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
Good morning.
How are you?
How are you?
What's up?
Hey.
Yes?
Okay. Hey, how old is that Jay guy?
That Jay guy?
Yeah.
24.
24?
That's it, Jay?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
7 year relationship.
Well, he doesn't know anything now about what's going on.
He's pretty.
I didn't realize it pretty much consumed his whole social life.
Yeah.
Everything he knows was that woman.
Absolutely.
You don't get involved that seriously at 17. What are you doing, Jay? What are you doing, Jay? I'm sorry, ma'am. He's not ready for you and your wild tactics.
Come on,
all right? No? He's not ready for your dungeon.
Oh, come on.
Okay, but thanks for calling.
Didn't even find anything out about her.
All right, tell me something about yourself.
Oh.
No, it's not for you. Yeah. Jay?
Yeah. You're
trying to turn him into a bad boy, is that
what
it?
Would you like me to do for you?
Oh, jeez.
Show me how to get back into the... Or tell me how to get back into the dating situation.
Okay, Jay, the first thing you have to do is go out today and buy Air Supply's Greatest Hits.
Cry your eyes off for 6 weeks
straight.
Make
it worse.
Where are you picking these songs? Does this represent Jay? Is this the song we can find that best represents Jay?
I think it does.
With my head on the phone.
Yeah, could it be, man?
You want me to show you the way, Jay?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Would you like to be laid by this weekend, Jay, or what? What are you looking for? What do you need?
That'd be nice, but it's not a must.
Huh? It sounds like to
it's
me
not
that
a
he.
Must.
You just kind of want to get your feet wet a little bit. You're not one of those type of guys that, hey, let me lay the first thing that I can.
Would you
find.
Rather have a Friday night dinner and a kiss on the cheek type date? Or go to her house and just slam her, bring her the ruckus big time. Some really hot woman.
Come on, Jay. Say the right one. Come on.
That'd be good after the Friday night dinner.
Give a day.
It usually is. You're out of the air. Yes, Tiny.
Man. Oh, man. This dude is on the phone, 24 years old, crying over one piece of ass. Oh, Lord. Boy.
It's the only piece of ass he's ever known.
Yeah.
That's sad. You can't find love in one piece of coochie.
What's that on a Hallmark card I saw recently?
I thought I did, but she showed me different.
Dude.
She showed you different?
Listen, women are like Lay's potato chips. You can't eat just one.
Oh!
Jeez.
It's the variety pack.
The variety.
And that's what Jay certainly does need now. The last thing you need now, Jay, is to get serious with somebody else.
Yo, taste the pudding.
Man, Tiny's just such a food-oriented guy.
Yeah,
he
really
is. Yeah. Everything.
Let's go down the frozen food section aisle now.
It's like a pizza. You can't slice it one way.
Right. It's like a Swanson frozen dinner.
Oh, my gosh.
You need to throw that crap in the microwave. Just go to town. Jay.
Yeah.
All right, listen. There's nothing magical I could say on the phone right now to you that's going to get you really started other than don't get serious anytime again soon. It's very simple to find some woman who is very much in the same state as you, because most of them are,
oh,
and get serious again real quick. You don't need that.
But he doesn't sound like he's the manipulative type of gentleman.
Terry. It's like you've been unfrozen after all these years, Jay. It's culture shock for you, dude.
It is, actually.
Man.
So how does he go about...
Day by day.
Okay.
Jay?
Yeah.
You've taken your first baby step, whether you know it or not, this morning. You call us again soon, all right?
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
Take care, sir. You feel better?
Yeah, a little.
Okay, why don't I?
The T-Man.
I spent 8 years trying to reach him, and then another 7 trying to keep him locked up because I realized that what was living behind that boy's eyes was purely and simply evil.
The T-Man Show. Have you ever paid the babysitter in dick? Then call us now. 1-866-663-T-MAN.
Okay, well, we all know that the T-Man was in San Diego for the Super Bowl. Well, fortunately, we just picked him up in Tijuana a couple of hours ago. He was face down in the gutter with women's panties over his head. Gave us the impression that he had a good time. So he'll be back tomorrow. Now, more of the best of T-Man.
Ah, look who's here to share some time with us this morning.
Morning.
How are you there, fine, sir?
I'm doing good. How about you?
Fine. What's new in your life, mofo? The real mofo? Are you still a married man, happily? What's the situation there?
No, no longer.
Really?
Yeah.
No longer happy or no longer married?
Both.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Wow, that's news.
That is news.
Yeah.
Just...
things happen.
Yes. Fine. But why did they happen? It just was something that was long overdue? Just another incident of you not being able to be faithful to this woman, or what?
Eh, I think it had something to do with the T-Man show.
Mm-hmm. And don't blame it on me, dude. You cheated on your wife with your mom long before you met me.
Yeah, that's true. But it just got brought to the surface a lot easier.
Mm-hmm.
So
the fact that we didn't inspire you, we didn't co-find you. You came and found us with that story.
Oh, sure, you know, everybody wants to win some money.
Mm-hmm. And you did, and you lost a wife. Was it worth it?
I don't know.
So are you seeing anyone now? Are you very available? What's the deal?
I'm not seeing anybody. I'm just trying to...
Are you still living with your soon-to-be ex... Is she soon-to-be, or she's already your ex-wife?
She's... Well, legally, she's not, but we're not together. I got my own place. So...
You do?
Yeah.
Wow. But that looks like a great spot, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Pretty cool, though. She stuck with you for a year and a half after the whole story came out, though.
Tell me you live in, like, a player pad now. Come on.
Oh, yeah. Every night, go out, get drunk,
but
have fun.
Are you living in some big penthouse or no?
No, it's a studio, but
mm-hmm.
It works. It's over by the water downtown.
It's got a mattress right in the middle with no sheet on it. Great for a coffee table. Just a nightmare.
Empty fridge. Just beer and water.
Well, man. Well, mofo, you know, when you come and visit, we love to have you here, and it's nice that you stopped down this morning, that we love to send you out on missions because you have never turned down anything we've suggested you do. We just don't know what the hell to do with you this morning. But it's always fun to try to figure it out, right?
Yeah.
What do you feel like doing? You feel like doing anything?
Yeah, let's do something fun.
Okay. There's the idea. David?
Yes?
What's on the calendar of things going on with the day that usually can inspire us to come up with something to have mofo do?
Well, it's...
what do you have going on there? What was the last thing we did? We had, we sent Ariel to trick-or-treating, and then what did you do last time, mofo?
Saw some guy's tits and said they're too big.
Man boobs. Yeah, that was a long time ago. All right, but what recently have you gotten from that calendar?
We did the dryer vent, Scared of Your Dryer Month.
That's right. Beware Your Dryer Month, it turned into, with old man Jim. So what is on the list today, Steve?
Well, there's National Applejack Month is continuing.
I don't see him as a Kellogg guy.
Okay. Physical Therapy Month.
It's not up his alley either.
Polish American Heritage Month.
Are you Polish?
No.
Are you American?
Yes.
All right, it's only half right, Steve. Keep going. Polish American Month?
Yeah, we're still dealing with, National School Bus Safety Week this week.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I don't see him as a flag waver.
We have Be Bald and Be Free Day.
Be what? Be bald?
And Be Free Day.
Yes.
And National Day of Concern about Young People and Gun Violence.
Okay, I'm not feeling it, but thanks for stopping by, Mom.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks for being here. Nothing's hitting me. Nothing's striking me.
None of those?
None of those.
Gay and Lesbian History Month?
Huh? I think you're onto something there. Continue on.
And
we're getting into the workable category now.
Let's
Is that
see.
It? That's it for the month, or what?
Well, there's Eat Country Ham Month, but I'm not so sure about that. I mean, there's stats on here, too, if you want that. Facts. Little factoids.
Oh, jeez.
You're a factoid guy, aren't you, Stanley?
I am. I have a whole list of that.
Uh-huh.
Would you like something like that?
Go ahead!
Okay. Let's see. A breastfeeding mother produces 45 gallons of milk. I don't know if we can do that. The average person takes 27 seconds to unhook someone else's bra during moments of passion. Let's see. There's...
Eat Country Ham Month. Eat Country Ham Month. Uh-huh. The average person takes 27 seconds to take off somebody else's bra in a moment of passion?
Yes.
27 seconds. Passion. Country ham.
And mofo.
Mm-hmm.
The bra I like.
You like the bra?
Yeah.
You're a bra guy?
I can beat 27
oh,
seconds.
Oh, is that right? Well, that's not what I'm seeing, mofo. Oh. We have any access to any bras besides Terry's that I'd hate to have her take? Wait a minute, what's the situation on that? Jimmy Fred, what's up in the green room? Don't I know that there's a whole bunch of stuff? Didn't I see a bra up there?
I'm pretty sure we have one from, like, a couple of years ago upstairs in our old green room.
Why is that there?
We just it's storage. We don't really have as much storage now that we're downstairs.
But why would we have a bra in there? Well, I remember seeing it too. Why is it there?
Something that we did a couple of years. We have lots of stuff up there.
Mm-hmm.
Blindfold,
yeah.
All right, go up and look and see if we have a bra. Eat Country Ham. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's coming together in my head, mofo. Yes. Yes.
Those wheels spinning.
Mofo, here's what's going to happen this morning, sir. And this will just add to your legacy.
Oh.
All right. You are going to go door to door, which you love to do, right?
Sure.
And it's always beautiful, no matter who answers the door, you say, good morning, sir or madam. Right?
Yeah, they give me that good, confused
that's
look.
That's right. We'll prepare a prepared statement for you, mofo. And you'll approach whoever comes to the door with your always ready salutation of good morning, sir or madam. And then you'll tell them about this record that you heard about. That it takes the average person, in the moment of passion, 27 seconds to take someone else's bra off. And you'll offer them $50 in cash.
Wow.
To take the bra that you'll have on off your body, mofo. And if they can do that in less than 27 seconds, you will give them $50 in cash. Now, the question, of course, is, people like $50 in cash? You never push aside $50 in cash, right, Terry?
Never.
No. But with a stranger like mofo standing on your doorstep, do you even contemplate the prospect of trying to take off his bra?
Well...
or do you race for 911?
I think you...
These questions and many others will be answered in a matter of moments.
Wow.
As we eat country ham, they have to reach around mofo's upper torso.
While they eat country ham?
Ah, look at that! It still has the tags on it. It's something we thought we were going to do, never wound up doing. There's a bra here, mofo, that still has the tags on it.
Yay! Right.
There's a big one, too.
Jeez.
What the hell were we thinking back then? Makes me wonder what we were going to do.
Wishful thinking for somebody?
It's a 40B?
Oh, 40B?
Do they make a 40B?
Well, like obviously they do.
Jeez, do they make a woman 40B is the question.
Mofo, it's smooth, it's pretty, it's lacy. It's never been touched. It was bought on sale for
$21. Wow, that's pretty inexpensive.
Mm-hmm. The manufacturer's suggested retail price was $26.50.
Oh, that's quite a steal.
Yeah. We know a good bargain when we see it.
Sure do.
Mofo, this actually is perfect for you because it's got a small cup size and reaches around.
Reaches around? Are we sure?
You're not the
around.
Smallest guy.
No, I'm not. I hope that 40's big enough.
So now we work out a prepared statement for you. You want to wing it? You better wing it, or do you like a prepared statement?
Give me something to start with.
You like a body of work to reference. I understand.
It's not prepared. It's going to be afraid of your bra month all of a sudden.
Yeah. Well, old man Jim doesn't like to bring something to read. Mofo likes to bring something to read.
Right.
If I don't give him this, he'll take a Sports Illustrated or something. So what do you think, Mofo? That sound good? Now, yeah, of course, where are we going to get the cash? We're going to have to make them sign something, or do I have to give them $100 or something like that?
You'll probably have to actually give them the money.
Because
they're going to say, well,
country ham.
Yeah, you like that better, huh?
I think people will do it if they see the cash.
Yeah,
I would
if
bet
they
people
see the
do
cash.
It.
If he shows them the cash.
Yes.
If a stranger like Mofo on their doorstep.
Right.
With a bra on. Yeah. And they're going to reach around and try to unhook his bra in 27 seconds.
Yes.
Now, do we tell them they're on the radio or no? I say no.
Well,
just
no.
Some stranger shows up at the door and offers him $50 to take off his bra.
Let's make up a day. It's a hurry, beat 27 seconds, take off your bra day.
Okay,
Terry,
how about you just leave it for us, okay? Mofo goes to the door, just tells them about this wonderful stat that has stimulated his mind in an intriguing fashion, and now he wonders whether they can do it, and he's willing to offer him $50 if they can.
I got $50 that says nobody answers their door.
I have $50 that says if they do answer their door, they slam it quick.
Right.
I guarantee you not one person, even though he shows them the cash. I'll give you the cash. Even though you show them the cash. I don't have to give you more than 50 because the odds are not one person is going to even remotely consider taking off some stranger's bra on their doorstep. Now, $1,000 maybe.
Now, is this like they have to, you know, reach around or I have to turn around?
No,
you don't turn around.
Oh, okay.
You let them reach around.
One hand or two hands.
And if they want to suck on your neck in the process.
Well, that's free.
Yeah. You let them know.
All right.
That's free. Sound good?
Sounds good.
Yes! Eat country ham, bud! All right!
The T-Man.
You are a son of a bitch! You know that?
The T-Man Show.
Hey, are you adding to the pussification of men? Well, call now. 1-866-663-T-MAN.
15 months ago, newlyweds Brad and Jennifer slapped a $50 million lawsuit on Italian jeweler Damiani. Charging that the company broke an agreement not to copy the white, gold, and diamond wedding bands Brad co-designed.
Mofo, are you familiar with this Damiani?
No,
I'm
not.
You visit him all the time?
No.
Is that where you get all your custom-made jewelry? From Damiani?
Charging that the company broke an agreement not to copy the white, gold, and diamond wedding bands Brad co-designed, and which the company made for them.
Whatever. Is that the most pretentious thing you've ever heard of? We have to have our own special, right, Unduplicated wedding band for Jennifer. And Damiani obviously didn't hold to his word. So Brad and Jennifer got all bent out of shape that someone else, possibly the notion that somebody else is wearing the same wedding band and ring, shape and size, that Jennifer has on her precious finger.
And to think, if it was somebody not rich and famous, oh my gosh.
Unbelievable. The thought of that is nauseating.
Common folk.
Ooh. Could be on Mofo's finger for all Jennifer knows.
The common unwashed, is that, sharing a bond.
Is that just overdone? Done or what?
The suit further claimed that photographs of the couple were used without their consent in ads for the company. But diamonds may indeed be a girl's best friend, okay, and her husband's too.
Right.
In January, Brad and Jennifer kissed and made up with Damiani
and settled
their legal problems. And today comes word that Jennifer is now appearing in overseas ads for the jeweler, but not in North America.
Okay.
As for Brad, he's getting in on the action as well. He'll be designing an exclusive collection for the company.
Okay, so on top of it all, they're both a bunch of sellouts.
So they just wanted to be paid for it.
There you go.
All it boils down to.
Apparently so. Money always talks in the end. In the meantime, we have more important things to discuss. We have written a statement for you to go to Front Doors. And Mofo made it very clear, Pasty, he'd like to go to different neighborhoods this time. He's getting too well known in the neighborhoods that you commonly go to. You always seem to go to the same neighborhoods?
Yeah.
All right.
They open the door. Hey, Mofo, what's going on?
The answer to the door. Mofo, listener. So this time we'll take you to a brand new area. Let's take him to a whole new city even. Where are you going to take him this time? All right, doesn't matter. Have you read through your statement? It's short, it's brief, it's didn't require a lot of thought from us, so perhaps it needs a little work, I don't know. Why don't you read through it, and we'll see how it sounds. Let me pretend like I'm answering the door. Okay. Okay, no, I don't answer the door to mofos.
Do you even answer the door?
I don't think so. No one comes to my door. Okay. They know better. All right, what do you got?
Okay, go. Excuse me, sir, madam.
Okay.
Are you aware that it takes the average person...
Stop right there. Stop right there.
Geez, you're excited, though.
Now, you know, again, that whoever answers the door, be it man or woman, you will say, excuse me, sir or madam.
I understand.
And you'll be looking right in their eyes when you say, excuse me, sir or madam.
Yes, I will.
Should he say, good morning, sir or madam?
Yes. Yeah, good morning.
All right, let's change that. A little alteration on your little script there, mofo. Rewrites the mofo line. I'm sorry.
The mofo line of excuse me, sir or madam, has just been changed to good morning, sir or madam.
We feel that's more in your character.
No.
Okay. We feel it's more in your character.
Yeah, I guess that's okay. What you think.
I don't know if you have your agent outside complaining or what, but this is the way we're going with it now, okay? Why don't you take two?
Alrighty.
Yes. Quiet on the show!
Good morning, sir or madam. Are you aware...
Why does everyone talk on speed?
They're nervous.
So to speak.
Quiet on the set! Speed!
Good morning, sir or madam. Are you aware that it takes the average person 27 seconds to unhook another bra in a moment of passion?
It's not another bra. It's another's bra. Meaning, does it say another bra or say another's bra?
It says another's bra.
Another's bra means someone else's. Because I'm sure it doesn't take somebody 27 seconds to unhook their own bra. I do it much faster than that. All right?
All right.
Do we understand now? Do you want us to change the wording? Are you not comfortable with that verbiage? Or you want to, because we can work with you, mofo. You're the talent.
Yes.
Okay?
Where's my Evian water?
Oh, jeez. Get him some Evian. Will Dasani do?
Yeah, I'll
okay.
Damn cheap.
Quiet on the set. Speed. Action.
Good morning, sir, madam. Are you aware that it takes the average person 27 seconds to unhook another's bra in a moment of passion?
Huh?
I am here today on your doorstep to make a one-time offer of $50 in cash to give to your...
Like a train wreck out of control. He's like a freight train just speeding too fast that you know is destined to fall off the tracks when he's reading like that. Do you know that?
He tries so hard to now, really get everything across.
If I may assist, mofo, you may want to slow it down. Flash a couple of pearly whites here and there to keep some kind of rhythm going, all right?
All right.
You're a friendly gentleman wearing a bra on their front door. And by the way, he has the bra on already. And it's even 40B is not nearly wide enough to really fit him comfortably. What is your chest? Do you know what chest size you have?
Probably around 46.
Okay. Well, it works. It clasped.
Yeah. Yeah. Quiet, speak, action!
Good morning, sir or madam.
That's well done, by the way.
Thank you.
You got the good morning, sir or madam done in a very friendly and passionate way. All right. And we appreciate that.
This is why we do rehearsal.
Okay.
All right. Are you aware that it takes the average person 27 seconds to unhook another's bra in a moment of passion? I am here today on your doorstep to make you a one-time offer of $50 in cash to give to you immediately or in place in your child's scholarship fund if you can take off my bra that I am wearing... off in less than 27 seconds.
Okay.
It's that last
You may not
part.
Want to improvise, man.
How about you just stick to the script?
All right. I would sense that they're going to lose you somewhere along the way here. But I think the key is for you to hold up the $50 in cash.
Mm-hmm.
All right? That may, even if they're not understanding you, keep them enthused, if you will. Yes, they're going to be, you keep in mind, they're going to be a little startled that they open the door to a man wearing a bra. But when you flash $50 in cash and you give them the very friendly good morning, sir or madam, I think all their worries will be going by the wayside. Mm-hmm. Sound good?
Sounds good.
Okay. Steven?
Yeah?
Do we need another rehearsal or do you think he's going to...
Well, a little bit in the last part, I think he needs a little...
Country ham day! Last one worked?
Well, I know he'll be fine, because through rehearsals, but once he's on, he usually gets it, and he usually nails it.
Okay. Pasty will be there to chaperone. If there's any problem, we yell abort. You and Pasty run for the hills. All right. With or without bra, I don't care.
Will Pasty be in view? Are they thinking, was that guy wearing panties down there? Mm-hmm. Yeah, what's next?
How many times does it take Mofo to get to the center of a script? it's not a Tootsie Pop. Mofo, yes, you and Pasty can head on out now with your script and your bra. We'll check in with you en route. You're obviously going to go a little bit further away. Is that fair to say? You're going to need a little bit more time.
Yep.
We're setting you to a new neighborhood with a new attitude. He's the real Mofo, ladies and gentlemen. Yay! It was just, what, 7 years ago the man was having sex with his biological mom.
Yeah.
And now look how far he's come.
Jeez. He's wearing bras
he's
now.
He's got a bra. He's willing to offer cash. Why, let me give you a little.
Yeah, give him the money.
Should I give him more than 50? No. I don't have change.
Give me 250s.
All right, here we go. Here we go.
You have 250s?
I don't know.
Just in case.
You're going to give him 100? Trust me. Not one person is going to start reaching their hands around Mofo and taking off this bra, but just in case.
Do we take any bets?
So does he say, I have $50 for you, and he's holding up a $100 bill?
You got change?
Yeah, you got change.
You're a winner, but.
Here it is, right here.
Yes.
I have 220s and 25s. There you go.
Okay.
220s and 25s.
Here's your
crumpled singles and change. Here you go, man.
I can't believe for our kicks, I got to reach into my wallet for this crap.
Would you like us all to put in a little bit? Is that?
No, it's not that. It's that we should have some kind of cash lying around. We should have a, what would they call that?
Petty cash?
A petty cash fund.
So that we can just dip in at any time?
Petty is the operative word in this phrase.
Well, where's the cash drawer?
We should have a cash drawer with $1.6 million in it. Man. All right, Mofo. You and Pasty head on out. We'll check in with you in a couple minutes. There you go. Mm-hmm. Have a good trip.
This ought to be great.
Yeah.
Huh?
Because the whole time he's sitting here with the bra on while he's...
Yeah, she's very comfortable in that bra, by the way. I think he's going to request that we let him keep the bra.
Well, he can,
I'm
as far
okay
as I'm
that.
Concerned.
Yeah. Yes. In the meantime, Terry, what do you have there? What are you working on in the newsroom?
Well, it's pretty shocking to learn
we don't have a
that,
cash drawer. We don't have a newsroom, ladies and gentlemen. Don't be fooled.
We have a news theme, though, by the way.
We do?
Yes.
The Terry Free news theme?
Oh, yeah.
Where's that? Is that it?
That should be it.
Oh, good. All right. Wow.
What are you working on there in the news? Oh, this is going to be played only once. Trust me.
Okay.
What are you working
news
on there in the newsroom there, Terry? Yeah, shocking news.
Shocking
do we have a shocking news theme?
There it is.
Let's play our shocking news theme, and here it is.
Shocking news out today. Men over the age of 65, it seems, are more concerned with their own length and girth than your average younger man.
Men over 65.
Over 65.
Why would they care? They're not having sex at
well,
over 65.
Some are.
Mm-hmm.
This
now
is a,
that the world has been introduced to Viagra, all of a sudden men over 65 are even more concerned.
Yes.
With the size of their male organs.
Right.
I'm glad we're playing the news theme for this one, Terry.
Sure you are. Good one.
Let's hear from one of those men right now. Doesn't sound over 65 to me.
Nope. Huh?
But here's someone who obviously is a little alarmed by that information as well.
And now, representing butt rockers worldwide, carrying sod from Tacoma to Everett and every city in between, president of the Blue Collar Workers, even though he wears a tank top, here's Dump Truck Guy.
Stop me!
Oh, what's happening, dude?
Stop me!
What's that?
Boy, oh boy.
How are you there, sir?
Man, I had a very interesting evening last night.
All right, tell us about it. What happened?
On
I'll bite.
Home, the old lady calls me up. Evidently, a couple thugs cruised through my neighborhood, tried to snag up on my kid and his little buddies.
Try to snag
Ooh,
up?
Really?
Meaning what?
Yeah.
They try to, like, grab and put your kids in their car?
They try to do the drive-by snagging. I guess you call it.
So Bubba was almost kidnapped, in a sense.
You're damn right. Him and four of his buddies.
Wow.
But luckily, Bubba's spiked hair was able to fend them off, or what?
No, he did the AB the AB configuration and made a beeline right into my yard where my dogs were at, and he was safe and sane.
So if I'm to get a visual of what transpired here on your own block, is that what you're saying?
Yeah, right in front of my house.
Somebody drives by in a vehicle, reaches out the car window, and tries to grasp onto Bubba's clothing in an effort to pull him into their car? Is that what you're saying, or what?
No, that's a negative. There's out there playing kickball. Evidently, the car drove through the neighborhood, stopped at the end of the street, backed up, and then two older gentlemen got out and started chasing the kids around, trying to grab them.
Over 65?
No, he said around my age, man.
Around your age, and they got out of their car and started running after the, how old is your son, 8, 9?
Yeah, he's 8.
And Bubba was able to outrun them.
You're damn right. Everybody got away, yeah, everybody made it home safe, but nobody got any license number, nobody got nothing. So I can say this, if you're hearing my voice and you're these people, come back to my neighborhood and I will kill you.
Ah! That's nice.
Sounds like quite an offer.
Yeah.
Right.
Wow.
Where do I sign?
Yeah.
I can't believe Halloween's in 3 days and people are pulling this kind of crap. Man.
Well, if you're inspired to grab a child, if that is truly your wish, you're telling me you can't outrun an 8-year-old?
Yeah, were they really trying to kidnap him, or are they just trying to goof on him and chase him around?
They're probably just trying to...
Well, who knows, man? I mean, they didn't stop and ask, are you trying to take me, or were we just playing tag?
And you're
in. You're in, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, a car with older dudes get out of it, and there's little kids playing, and they don't know them.
Yeah,
they're hauling ass.
And as a father, I understand your passion here, but if you're really motivated to grab a kid and that is what your intent is, and you get out of your car, I mean, you grab onto them. I just think maybe they're trying to mess with them, which is very wrong, and just as serious, that would anger a father. And luckily, that probably wasn't their intent, but maybe it was. Maybe it is exactly how Dumpy says it. Bubba outran them back home. And so did all the other kids.
Well, I can pretty much say Bubba's on lockdown now. He ain't going outside the gate.
No, that's good for Bubba.
You're a prisoner in your own yard.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm sorry that happened to you and your family, Dumpy.
No problem, man. I appreciate your sympathy.
You see what happens due to the success of the Dumpies?
Yeah.
No. I don't think no correlation. I don't think anybody has the balls to do it.
Ow! If they would have known it was Dumpy's son, they would have steered clear. Wow.
Not even a description of the car or anything?
No, just a big, long silver car. Who knows? It could have been a V-Dub for
did
all
you,
I know.
Did
this
you,
8-year-old kids, man.
Did you call the police or no?
Yeah, we called them about 5:30. I think they showed up about quarter to midnight. Because it's not an emergency, you know?
Mm-hmm. That
but
wouldn't
needless
be...
to say, I want to thank them because I'm freaking a half hour late to work because of that.
All right. Well, that's interesting. Thanks for sharing, Dumpy. I'm sorry
you
that happened to you.
Have a good day, brother.
At least your wife won the post down.
Yes, you did.
Take care. Dump truck guy, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow.
That'd be scary, though.
That'd scary, no matter how you slice it, but you're a... Dumpy's what, 33?
Something
you're a 33-year-old man, gets out of a car and really wants to grab one of the kids there. I think you're pretty successful. I mean, in the warped mind of someone, if that's really what they're thinking, you grab onto them. If you just try to get out and mess with the kids, watch them run.
Ooh.
People do that too, which is wrong. Scare the whole block.
Yeah, the whole
there's no 10-year-old that can outrun me.
Oh,
that's safe
geez.
To say. I'm faster than every 10-year-old out there.
And Hotshot is tipping the scales at a good 3-0-2.
The T-Man.
What are you people? On dope?
You're listening to the best of T-Man. The T-Man will be back on tomorrow. We did happen to find him. He's in Tijuana. Once we heard that, we knew there was trouble. So he'll be back tomorrow. His Super Bowl party continues. But now more of the best of T-Man.
In a town where the movies sometimes last longer than the marriages, divorce can get downright dirty.
That's great. Why?
I get it. Movies are short.
In a town where the movies sometimes last longer than the marriages, divorce can get downright dirty.
Hey, you don't have time to Make the Raisin Nets thing happen. Damn shame.
These are some of the wildest divorce claims I've ever seen.
And when there's so much money at stake, it appears that no divorce demand is too outrageous.
Right.
The $500,000 she was asking for was not per year. It was per month.
Okay. Family law attorney...
But you need $500,000 a month to live, Terry.
Of course.
Oh, how could you live on anything less?
It'd be tough.
Jeez. The $500,000 she was asking for was not per year. It was per month.
Of course. How could you have been confused? I wasn't.
Family law attorney Lynn Sudik says the most unusual demands often end up before a judge.
Right.
In one case, this woman asked the judge to have use of the party's private jet. The husband refused. She said, "You don't understand. The flights, the commercial flights, don't leave when I want to."
Prenup special.
That makes sense to me.
Yeah, they never do they?
And I don't know where that barf bag's been.
Leave when I want to.
Prenup specialist Arlene Dubin says the outrageous requests can start even before the wedding.
Mm.
The fling fee is a very popular request.
The what fee?
Fling fee.
Oh, the fling fee. That bastard that I'm about to marry cheats on me,
right.
I get a certain allotment of cash fee.
I get a lump sum of this.
It's all in the throes of love.
Of course.
Yeah.
And commitment, you know.
Mm-hmm.
The fling fee is a very popular request.
What if he literally just picks her up and flings her across the room? Is that covered under the fling fee?
Yes.
Here's $2 billion. Good job.
The fling fee is a very popular request. In the prenup with Michael Douglas and Catherine Zeta-Jones, there was reportedly a fling fee of $5 million that he would have to pay her if he cheated on her.
Very worth it.
Yeah.
If you're Michael Douglas.
Michael
Douglas has got to have $5 million sitting around in a safe, right?
Right. Well, but...
Thinks to himself, wow, what a piece of ass. All right, here's the money. I'm going for it, baby.
And didn't he give, like, his ex-wife a big chunk of change?
Yes.
He was real generous.
He gave
with
her
that.
60% as opposed to 50%. He's really helping the system.
Right.
Oh, we really have a lot that we owe to Michael Douglas as men of the world.
Right.
He felt that she wasn't able to live on just 50%. Everyone complains about having to give half.
Right.
But he's bigger than that.
Why would
and now he puts fling fees in his new prenup.
Sure.
Why would he do that? I mean, he's carved out a nice life for himself in a position where he wouldn't have
because
to do that.
Because he left a wife of like 20 years to be with Catherine Zeta-Jones. He traded in his wife who had been loyal to him and stood by him all his life. Yeah. And he felt so guilty about it that he thought he could relieve his guilt by giving her more than the average Hollywood divorced person has to give.
I'm talking about the fling fee. He should not have to do that, should he?
Well, Catherine Zeta-Jones knows his history.
Yeah. She talked to the ex-wife.
That it's like money in the bank. Why not? The only question is, who's going to be the hot piece of ass that walks into Michael Douglas's life that's worth it? Who's worth the $5 million price tag of a fling fee?
I mean, is it $5 million per fling, or is it...
You fling once, you pay the fee.
Okay,
well, what if she stays married to him? Does she
still... that's what I was wondering.
Yeah.
Okay, so he says, okay, there's your $5 million for that fling. She goes, okay, I'm cool. We won't get divorced. And the next thing you know, he says, I have to have another fling. She goes, well, there's another $5 million.
Well, yeah, the cash register keeps ringing on up there.
All right.
Who's fling potential?
If they stay married, you have to forfeit the $5 million, I think.
Yeah, it's only if they get divorced, I guess. I don't know. Sits there with a huge
cash register.
Yes.
Ching,
all of a sudden,
ching.
This money piled up all around her, and they're still married and in love.
$5 million plus tax.
Reportedly, reported that Melanie Griffith had a prenup with Don Johnson,
right,
in which she agreed not to gain any weight during the marriage.
Oh, I love that. You can put that in a prenup.
Yeah, sounds like it,
man. You gain 1 pound. That's $5 million. Are you serious? Don Johnson put that in his prenup with Melanie Griffith?
The audacity to look at your wife and say that to her.
I know.
She is like one of those ladies who is so insecure about the way she looks and stuff. You hear about it all the time
right.
in the tabloids.
So she used the prenup as incentive.
Probably.
She begged him to put that in the prenup.
Yeah, had a sure. prenup with Don Johnson in which she agreed not to gain any weight during the marriage. In exchange, he agreed to be faithful to her.
Wow, there it is again, that fling fee. This fling fee, I'll tell you right now, is adding to the pacification of men.
Tom Cruise and Nicole Kidman used private mediators to keep their divorce settlement out of the public eye.
Yeah.
But some Hollywood splits end up being very nasty.
Oh, geez.
I represented Nick Nolte's wife. She found out she was getting divorced by watching Entertainment Tonight.
And he's doing better for it.
Oh, yeah.
He's trying to rape himself.
Yes. They found the date rape drug in his system that he apparently took himself.
Yes.
He needs to get himself all looped up so he can be jerking the gherkin or something.
Right. Come
on, There's a case when a Hollywood actor had to go to court to get permission for his daughter to meet the president of the United States.
Right.
Because his wife refused because it wasn't his weekend with the child.
That's not his weekend.
Wow.
All right. You stick the Dairy Queen on your weekend, all right? That's the way it works.
Pasty!
Yes, sir.
Where are you? Are you in position? Are you still driving? What are you doing there?
We've actually just pulled up to a new little neighborhood here.
Ooh. New little neighborhood, new little attitude, and Mofo still feels comfortable in his bra?
Well, yes. He's been going over the script a couple times here to make sure he's got everything right.
Okay, now what originally inspired this, Stephen? It's National Ham Day?
Yeah, it's Go Hog Wild and Country Ham Day.
Mm-hmm, it's Country Ham Day.
Yeah.
Was that it?
No, I think it was the factoid.
You read us a factoid. You love saying the word factoid for some reason.
Yeah. He does.
It's adding to the gigification of men. And what was the exact factoid there, Stephen?
The average person takes 27 seconds to unhook someone else's bra during moments of passion.
During moments of what now, Steve?
Passion.
A passion?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Well, is there a passion clause in your prenup, Steve?
I've seen a weight clause.
Ow! Well, we going to take that from him?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's true.
So Mofo's ready to go?
Oh, yes. It doesn't get much more passionate than this, right?
Ladies
here.
And gentlemen, the real Mofo, your dysfunctional family member number 4. Is that right, number 4? Okay, good. Has on a 40B sized bra.
Yes.
In an effort to go to people's doorways and see if they're willing to try to beat the average time that it takes to unhook a person's bra in the moment of passion for paying all the cash.
Wow.
I don't know. Is he filling out the bra? Does it look good at least?
Oh, yeah. Steven.
Only you could answer that.
Jeez. Is Mofo there? Does Mofo know to keep the phone by his ear while looking all natural?
How do you do that?
Believe it or not, people never say, hey, what are you doing with a phone to your ears? They never have. We've got to many doors, and no one's ever said that. People are so just accustomed to seeing people with phones to their ears, they don't even notice anymore.
I know. You're right.
Yes. Is Mofo ready?
Yes, he is.
Can you put Mofo on the phone?
Hello?
Mofo, how do you feel?
Just trying to cover up as much as I can in front of the traffic going by.
Mm-hmm. You're in a high traffic area and you would not rather see people drive by with you wearing a bra?
That's correct.
All right. Well, no one knows you in whatever town you're in. This is far away from your home front, right?
Yes, it is.
All right, so let yourself be free.
Yeah,
embrace the bra. Hug yourself right now. Okay. Are you at a door that looks like it's occupied by someone that is actually home?
Yes, there's lights on, and it looks like someone's home.
Mm-hmm.
Three cars.
Wish the same could be said about you, dude.
All right.
Whenever you're ready, why don't you approach the front door?
Oh, boy.
Okay, I'm heading up the steps.
You're what?
Heading up the steps. Huh?
Let's hear a big knock from a man with a bra. Mofo?
Yeah, I'm still walking.
Do you need to go over your script at all? You feel good?
No, I'm feeling pretty good.
You're feeling good.
He does.
Okay, here comes the knock.
He's feeling good.
Big knock.
I mean, a knock to me.
He's a big knocker.
And now he has big knockers for his bra. Make sure you show him the cash.
I will.
Yeah, the 220s.
Fan it out.
Again.
Fan it out for him.
Right.
Okay, it's gone well so far.
Can we ring a doorbell?
Is there a doorbell?
No, there's a little kid sitting there. So
there's a little kid sitting there. He's been there for years. Is he scratching at the window?
No, but he's coming to the door. The little kid is.
Oh.
Huh?
No.
All right, no, don't do it to the little kid. See if there's a parent at home.
Your daddy home?
Jeez, that's always nice.
You get your parents?
Should ask for mommy.
Mommy?
Look, he looks like mommy.
There. No one's there?
Well, just a little kid. Don't come to the door.
All right, go to the next house. Okay. Tell him to have a nice day. Pat the little... Don't touch the kid.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry your parents abandoned you,
right.
Man. Here's a Pop-Tart. Have a good morning.
How old was the kid?
Probably about 4.
All right, have Pasty call Child Protective Services, right. And you may want to go to a new block after that.
Jeez. All right.
Or the way out of there, maybe you want to call somebody for that kid.
Wow.
All right, I'm approaching a new house.
He's like, no, have you seen them?
Yeah, right.
Are you my daddy?
Jeez.
Wow. Nice bra, mister.
You see the things you find, Terry, when you walk to someone's front door with a bra on?
Yes.
Go ahead there.
Okay, I'm going to knock.
Did you use the actual knocker on their door, it sounded like?
That's my knuckles.
Oh.
Screen door, maybe?
Sounds the same.
Yeah. A lot like a knocker.
Punch right through the screen door to get to the other door. We adults open it.
There's a two-year-old home alone at this house.
Yeah, right.
Oh, it's Macaulay Culkin!
Oh, this house is empty.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well.
I keep working. Oh,
there's no furniture unless they're, like, Hindu or something.
What? How does that even...
Mm-hmm. Mofo is very well versed with the Hindu customs, Terry.
I guess
didn't
so.
You know that? Did you see the dot on his forehead? Okay, next house, please, Mofo.
All righty.
Yes.
In the Quran, it says, thou shalt not have furniture.
Right.
I've seen
it. Backyard here.
What's that now?
I head to the backyard. That's where we saw the person.
You're going to the backyard?
Are you going to?
I don't like you in backyards,
yeah,
Mofo.
Careful about that.
Mofo, no. Stay clear of backyards.
Okay. There's no escape route.
Yes.
Right. Okay?
Plus, there are dogs. There's ways of trapping you. I don't want to hear anything bad happen.
There's bats and, you know, those barbecue pokers and stuff.
See yourself as, I don't know, a salesman, if you will. But keep in mind, I don't know why you're asking for dads when you know the goal of this is to get someone to reach around you in a passionate way and unhook your bra.
Yeah, I know, but that's what I saw. I was roaming around outside, so I figured that's all that was there.
You might want to ask for ladies.
All right.
But go ahead. Continue on.
Listen, it wasn't an owner. It was the burglar trying to get in.
Anyone else there?
Hey, I'm walking to a house now.
Okay. Is Pasty keeping up?
Breathing heavy.
I'll knock anyways.
All right. This house what?
You have a doorbell, but I'm knocking anyway.
Okay, you're a knocker.
They have furniture. Oh, they're Mormon.
Not going so well so far, huh, Mofo?
No, I'm using the doorbell. Oh, here comes somebody.
Okay, here we go. Woman or man?
I think a woman.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Good morning, sir or madam. Are you aware that it takes the average person 27 seconds to unhook another's bra in a moment of passion? Listen to this. It's a deal for you. It'll be a good deal. I'm here today in your doorstep to make a one-time offer of $50, which I got right here in my hand. If you can unhook my bra within 27 seconds or less. Can't put them down for a second? You think I can bum a smoke or anything?
Jeez.
All right, take a look.
There you go. All right. Not going so well so far.
No.
Oh, my God.
Make sure he's aware there's an abandoned kid two houses down the block.
Right.
All right, Mama, we'll check back with you a little later, okay? You keep looking for houses.
All right.
It's not going too poorly thus far. At least he was willing to listen to you.
Yeah.
He didn't laugh at you with your bra on, right?
No, he just looked at me like I was strange.
Well, you should be used to that.
Yeah.
All right. The
T-Man. Why can't I just have a normal boyfriend? Why? Just a regular boyfriend who doesn't go nuts on me.
Everybody wants that, dear. It doesn't exist.
Have nothing on but baby oil, then call us now. 1-866-663-T-MAN.
In the new movies, real women have curves, plus-size actresses stripped down to their underwear.
Oh, geez.
We have the reason why they do it.
Well, please tell me, because I can't think of one. What is this now? You ever heard of this movie? I haven't heard of this movie. What's the name of the movie?
I haven't heard of it.
In the new movie, real women have curves, plus-size actresses stripped down to their underwear. We have the reason why they do it.
What, is it in those artsy theaters or something?
Yeah.
Because I don't think it's
like
a mainstream
that.
Movie. Have you heard of it, Steven?
I have not.
Real women have curves. You've heard of it, Terry?
I have. I've heard of it, and it is one of those artsy type.
Yeah, it's in every city in the country, especially major cities, have those artsy theaters.
Yes.
I never go to them.
But
like even the Seinfeld movie right now, I think it's only playing in those artsy theaters, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why can't he get in the mainstream theaters?
Not sure.
Well, above that. It's probably his idea. He wants to keep it limited, so it makes a bigger buzz, yada, yada, yada. That's the way. is gonna be.
In the new movie, Real Women Have Curves,
right?
Plus-size actresses stripped down of their underwear.
Oh.
We have the reason why they do it.
Oh.
How dare anybody try to tell me what I should look like or what I should be when there's so much more to me than just my weight?
Oh, jeez, I gotta run out and see this.
When there's so much more to me than just my weight.
Yeah, but no one notices that.
Oh, no.
A woman who is a size zero, that's normal. And if you're anything above that, then you're abnormal. I think it's going to take other women to stand up and say, we are normal.
Okay, there you go. This is for all the normals.
Yes.
Other women to stand up and say, we are normal.
Which is exactly what happens when America's character, Anna, strips down in a dress factory.
You want to see cellulite?
Anna! What a great name for a fat woman!
Now.
Which is exactly what happens when America's character, Anna, strips down in a dress factory.
You want to see cellulite?
Oh, jeez.
All right, here we go.
Oh, boy.
Do you want to see it?
Yes. And everyone turns to the person that they're with and says, yeah, thanks for dragging me to the Artsy Theater. This is great.
It was actually got some kind of award recently.
Are you inspired to see this movie, too?
Yes, I think it sounds very
appealing, interesting,
and, yes,
intriguing,
mm-hmm,
chubby.
Not chubby. Yeah. I just think it's actually more realistic,
mm-hmm,
than what's really out there.
Wow! So everything out there is a big just lie, a bogus scam to dupe you into entertainment when this is true reality movieville.
Yeah, I think that I think
movieville horror.
This represents more what's in reality in the real world here.
Well, I don't
yes
see you racing for a ticket.
Well, I don't know where it's playing.
I hear you talking. I don't see you looking in the newspaper.
Well,
to find out where it's playing. I don't see you talking about any matinee.
That's the only way she goes to the theaters, if she knows where it's playing. Mm-hmm. Someone tells her. Then she'll go.
Someone's got to plop her in front of a theater.
Right. I actually had just recently heard about it and have seen little snippets, about.
There's nothing little about this movie, too.
Well,
she'll wait until Schubert has the DVD, and then she'll go into the prize closet.
Oh, I see.
Oh, jeez.
Yes.
All right, here we go.
America says that the movie had trouble getting made in part because the filmmakers couldn't find an actress who was willing to gain weight and look unattractive.
Wow. Well, they could have just found any housewife out there.
Oh, now. That's not true.
Any woman who's been married at least 2 years is a candidate for this part.
Have you seen her picture? Do you know what she looks like?
I don't know. Well, are you looking at it right now?
I am.
Is she an attractive Lane Bryant type lady or what?
She's all right.
Ah, look at the Weeman. Jimmy Fred Weeman is already found it, and he's turning it towards us right now, and from this distance, I can't tell a thing. She actually looks pretty attractive from this distance. Mm-hmm.
She's not bad.
Mm-hmm.
Jeez.
She apparently gained weight from the movie he screened from Beyond the Glass, I think. Is that what you screamed? In your low voice?
Put on weight for the movie.
Oh, okay. She was an unknown actress. She was the only one willing to gain weight for the part.
And looking like that, she's just going to stay unknown for a while.
Oh, jeez.
You know,
so she doesn't look good. I think from a distance she looked okay. You don't think so?
I saw the E.T. feature with her stripping down in her lingerie.
And?
I was sick to my stomach.
Oh, jeez.
And then he wonders why he's so single.
Yeah.
And why he's
such a prize.
High-fiving the Philadelphia Eagles on Monday Night Football or whatever.
His closest thing to a relationship is Donovan McNabb.
Right.
Terry's very sensitive about the weight issue, though, with him. Seems
he says it, I am, too.
Yeah, it's
who the hell is he?
Right. I mean, he's Mr. Shorty, okay?
Oh, wow.
And we say it like a little tongue-in-cheek. He says it all serious.
Mm-hmm.
Man.
And he's over here trying to say, oh, and you're Miss Shorty. You know what? It's way more acceptable.
He's
again
changed my opinion. I only want big ladies from now on. Pasty!
Yes,
speaking
sir
of big ladies.
Hey.
How you doing out there, bud?
We're doing okay here.
Mofo enjoying his run so far or what?
Oh, yeah, he's having a good time.
You moved to a new neighborhood? You got concerned?
Definitely. Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
We don't like sticking in one place for one more than
yeah, Pasty's learned.
Yeah. Hurry, knock and dodge.
Yes. He's really good at avoiding 5-0, let me tell you. Okay, so what is Mofo doing right now?
We just got out, and we're going to walk up. We saw a couple of
Do we even do this again? I mean, he's given it a shot. The first guy slammed. First off, he said it was going to be a woman coming to the door.
Yeah.
He's a real good judge of gender. This dude answers the front door, and we got pretty much what we're going to get from every house.
We didn't even give the four-year-old a shot.
Did he flash the money? Are you watching from a distance, Pasty, or are you right there with him? What are you doing?
I'm watching from a distance.
And
the money out.
From your vantage point, what was your interpretation of his performance?
Mofo's?
Yes.
Mofo did a great job. He did everything he was supposed to do. He had the money out in his hand. He was
really friendly to the guy. The guy looked like, you know, he just didn't want anything to do with him.
Mm-hmm.
But Mofo was doing a good job.
And how would you react if a guy came to your door wearing a bra?
I'd probably take the $50.
Okay.
Yes. And now, then close the door.
Are you in a high-income type neighborhood or no?
Well, no, we're at a moderately priced.
Okay, let's play a little real estate roulette to discover that.
While we're at it.
Love it.
Yes. What is the house you're looking at? Please describe.
Okay, the first one we're going to go up to here is a two-story, I'd say maybe the, maybe two, three-bedrooms. No, maybe two bedrooms.
Huh?
Pretty small. I'd say square footage, we're looking at about 1,700.
Hmm.
Nice little
normal
deck on the front. Little walkway, nice little yard, carport on the side.
Carport, not a garage, right?
No, it's got a little garage, it looks like, actually, in the back, after further inspection.
All right, here we go.
Yes. It definitely needs a paint job.
You want to see cellulite?
So it's much older, much of an...
There. And they're coming to the door.
Are they already?
Oh, wow.
Well, did he knock?
What's that?
What is he doing?
No, nothing.
Are they just noticing you walking through their yard?
No, just, yeah.
LeBron.
This is the guy with the brawn in our yard.
Do you want to talk with them or what?
Do I?
Are they trying to get your attention or no?
No.
Okay.
They're ruining our real estate roulette.
Well, I've heard this summary of this house that they're staring at, Terry, and I'm suggesting this house costs $198,000.
Okay.
Yes, in resale value.
Yeah. All right.
The carport is 170 of that $1,000.
Right.
What do you got?
I will go. I'll go a little bit lower and say about 175.
175 mm-hmm. for this house with three bedrooms that he described.
Well, he said two or three.
All right.
So
you're leaning more
sure.
towards believing it's two.
Yes.
Okay.
May I ask a question?
Go ahead, there, Stephen.
Did you go to the east side, or are you still in this part of the?
He's not allowed to tell you that.
Oh, really?
No.
Okay. Then I will go at 220.
We'll probably never find out because Mofo's got to do his deal first. Heaven knows they're not answering the door after that. All right, is Mofo ready?
Yes, he is.
Can you pass the phone to him?
Yes.
All right.
Can I make a wager?
That's good, solid.
Where's Mofo?
I'm here.
You feeling confident?
Yeah.
You're not losing your spirit, are you?
No.
Okay.
Let me head on up.
Sure.
Okay.
That's the idea.
Where are you?
Walk up the steps. I'm getting ready to knock.
Yes. He's ready to knock on the two or three bedroom.
He's not.
A rambler. Was it a rambler?
Good morning, sir, madam. Oh. Are you aware that it takes the average person 27 seconds to unhook another's bra in the moment of passion? Okay. I am here today on your doorstep to make you a one-time offer of $50, which I have right here in my hand, if you could unhook my bra that I am wearing right now in less than 27 seconds.
Okay.
Are you ready to try?
Sure.
Okay, hold on.
Come on,
man. We got a willing person here.
Mm-hmm.
Let me, you got to do it. No, you do it like from me facing each other.
Okay.
Okay, on your mark.
Tell him you kind of like him.
Stop it.
Go.
Who's counting?
Dang.
Two.
I'm watching the clock.
I don't think we get any takers.
Six. Seven.
How's he doing?
It's 10 seconds. He got it.
Really? Wow.
All right.
Wow. Yeah, it's unbelievable. We have a winner.
We do. You want taco?
Oh, my gosh.
No.
We're just give him the $50.
Just give him the $50. Tell him you'll call him.
All right. Thanks.
Wow.
Well done.
Taker. Yeah,
was he a strapping man there?
Yeah, absolutely.
Huh?
What was that?
Was he a good-looking guy? Were you curiously aroused there, Mofo, or what?
No, his beard was scratching my face.
Oh, that's always fun.
How much was his house worth?
Yeah. Oh, geez.
Yeah, knock on his door. Ask him what his home's worth.
Go back on it.
Something tells me he wasn't in an affluent area, Stephen, if that answers your question.
Yeah.
That's the guy jumped at the $50.
Did he just shut the door and...
$1.
Did he thank you or what?
He what? Yeah, he's a thing.
Did he tell you he at least liked you as a friend?
Yeah, had a nice night.
No panties today. Hey, we're doing a game. We need to know the value of your house.
Value of my house? Probably about $230,000.
$230,000.
Wow. Hotshot
Scott
nails it. Right on top.
All right, tell him thank you.
Okay, well, thank you again.
Ask him what he's doing on Friday night.
What?
There's two games in one.
Hey. Wow. He had a 50% success rate right there. I would have never believed it. The guy reached around you and unhooked your bra. Is that right?
That's correct.
He said the beard was scratching his face. Cheek to cheek.
Did he look like a single man?
I heard kids yelling in the background, so yeah, big kids.
Wouldn't it have been nicer if you had a woman answer the door?
Yeah, it's a big breath of air.
What? Say again?
With big breathlessness.
Yes, that would have been nice. All right, we can only dream now. Huh, mofo?
Yeah.
So where...
One more in your wallet, we'll come back, we can try again.
Huh?
He's ready to go out for some more.
Get some more money out of your wallet.
Did you put the bra back on, or is it off now?
It's off right now.
Ask him if he'd like to keep the bra, and he'll sign it.
Keep
I go walk all the way back up there?
No, it's all right.
Okay.
Well done, mofo.
Good job,
good
mofo.
Job,
you
mofo.
Can come back now. 10 seconds, ladies and gentlemen.
Very good.
What the hell is going on out there, Terry?
I have no idea.
Maybe later what? Maybe later what? Oh, no! With a beard that scratches?
Want to see cellulite?
The T-Man.
Have you seen my baseball?
The T-Man Show. Hey, do you think Gay really loves his pappy? Then call us now. 1-866-663-T-Man.
Why would you do that to a happy little creature that... It's fluffy. I mean, I'm fluffy. Not like I am carrying a gun. I'm fluffy.
And we still, to this day, don't have an answer. Hey, Steve and Mofo on their way back to the studio, Terry, and I see a large pile of accumulation of stories.
Yes.
Sitting over there in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want them to be neglected, Terry, even though I'm ready to go to phone calls for the first time this morning.
All right.
So please give us a couple of ditties, would you please?
Sure, I will. This happened in Kenosha, Wisconsin, a 22...
I've been wondering what's been going on in Kenosha, Terry.
Yeah.
So I'm glad you could be there to fill me in.
22-year-old gentleman was arrested after he allegedly entered an apartment, crawled into bed with a woman and her boyfriend, and proceeded to molest her.
Mm-hmm. You would have preferred him molest him?
No, but it's just a pretty freaky situation.
It is a little freaky, Terry, but when you're that desperate, it calls for desperate measures, I guess.
I guess so.
Gotta get your ass... In any way possible, I guess this perhaps got this guy in a little bit of trouble, huh?
Yeah, he began fondling and kissing the victim on her face, breasts, and body.
Well, how fast did he take the bra off, Terry?
I don't know.
27
say.
Seconds or less? Do we owe him $50, too, in Kenosha?
The victim told police that all that touching awoke her, and then she reached for her boyfriend to see he was sleeping, and then all of a sudden she turned around and boom, there's this dude.
This
in
dude
bed.
Just in bed. You think you can go to bed with a little peace of mind in this world?
Yes.
Well, you may want to lock the screen door on occasion.
Yeah, think?
How did he get in? Does it say?
Yes, it does say he entered through an unlocked door, they believe.
Well, you know what? Yes, you live in Kenosha. You feel safer than the average person, but apparently you still got to lock your door.
Mm-hmm.
Leave your door open. You get what's coming to you.
Oh, thank you.
Times are changing in Kenosha, aren't they?
Right,
yeah. It used to be a safe place.
Right.
The boyfriend did get a good punch in, though.
Oh, he did?
Yes.
Well, that's good to know.
Yes.
Yes. Nothing like a good Kenosha right hook. 1-866-663-T-MAN. I'm about to go to the phones and take calls on anything that is on your mind.
Okay.
One more, Terry.
All right.
1-866-663-T-MAN. Go ahead, Terry.
How about
Terry.
This? A man has been sent to jail.
Is this in Kenosha?
No.
Oh, damn. Where is Kenosha, Terry?
In Wisconsin.
Yes. All right. Fine.
I don't know how close to Oshkosh.
Bagosh?
There is an Oshkosh, Wisconsin. My mom's from Wisconsin. So.
Wow.
That's how I know.
Which
Lacrosse.
Mom? Something tells me it's pretty close.
Probably.
Yeah, probably so.
No matter where you are, it's close.
1-866-663-T-MAN. Yes, last story. Go ahead, Terry.
A man has been sent to jail after hacking into his ex-girlfriend's account. email account and then sending pictures of them having sex to all her friends and relatives.
You can't do that?
No, not well.
You sentenced to jail for that?
Yeah.
You can go to jail? I guess it's hacking. Is hacking carry a little jail time?
Invasion someone's privacy? I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
But where's the fun of the world, Terry, anymore? Do you have to go to Kenosha to find it?
I guess so.
Man. But the guy who crawled into the woman's bed and started fondling her, he got community service.
Yeah, right.
That's not an offense punishable by jail time. 1-866-666-3-T-Man, you're on the air.
Yep, this is the guy with the Volkswagen Jetta from yesterday, T-Man.
Oh, geez, are you getting obsessed? What's the deal?
Well, you know, not very upset, but I was actually thinking about selling the car anyway. So
you said that
wondering.
Yesterday.
Say again?
You haven't had a good last 24 hours, is that it?
Well, exactly. You know, the fellow soldiers, they've been riding me all...
riding
you. Okay, uh-huh. You better choose your words carefully from now on, right? Especially
okay, well, maybe...
after... Ladies and gentlemen, if you weren't tuned in when this guy got his problem surfaced yesterday, so to speak, we read a list of the... It had just come out. What was the deal? Had it just come out?
Yeah.
Yes. Top 10 gayest cars that are out there list... And I'm sure there were a number of drivers that were driving a bunch of those cars that were listed on the top 10 of those cars. You were, yes, driving the number one car.
Yeah.
But you seem to be having a huge issue with this.
Well, it was the number one car, but again, okay, my car is black, so you don't have to worry about...
Oh, it's black! Well, I'm just saying, so it says on this little list that any car that's black just voids out the gayness.
Right. Yeah, well, I'm just saying, you know, there's no chance that it's going to be that you're going to be considered the kid grabber,
mm-hmm.
and you won't get your butt kicked by the dump truck
okay.
driver.
Right.
So, I mean, if you buy the car...
You sure it's not yellow with a banana seat?
I'm pretty sure. I think that's only in the bugs. I think I stated that yesterday.
Okay, yes.
Okay, but, you know, I'm really looking to sell it. I'm asking for your guys' permission if I can say on my website when I put it up.
Oh, jeez.
You know...
Ionagaycar.com?
Actually, I was just going to put, you know, as heard on the T-Man, but I had to ask your permission for that, you know?
You could put that.
Okay,
fine.
You know?
I don't know you from a hole in the wall. It's just like, have you called before yesterday or no?
Well, actually, I have. I had talked to you about some diamond ring before.
We have.
Yeah.
So we've spoken on the show before.
Well, you
now
know...
Now you're tired.
Yeah,
and you have,
like
your,
really
you have your own website?
Well, I'm going to go ahead and set it up now.
Now he's going to, that he's got your permission.
All right.
Yeah,
T-Man's cars.com.
I'm waiting for a cover, you know.
All right, just don't use my name and your website address.
Okay, not in your website address. It'll be all me, but I will contact you once it's up, so that way
I can't wait.
You can check it out.
And thank you for updating us, sir.
Hey, no problem. I appreciate
all right, you take care now.
Hey, my number one fan, Scott Hanner, says hello, by
all
the way.
Right, there you go. You have a number one fan. Well, I'll have to tune into your show sometime.
No, not you. That's what I meant. I meant your number one fan.
Very good. Thanks a lot.
When are you going to give something away? Let's call.
Yeah.
1-866-663-T-MAN. I'm telling everyone out there, it's a wide open array of topics available to discuss. What is ever on your mind? Anything? Don't cough in my face, please. Okay. Anything you feel you need to get off your chest? Now is the time to call. You're on the air. Hi.
Yes. Terry Free.
Yes.
Let's get personal.
We're not playing the game.
We're not playing Let's Get Personal right now, but since you brought it up, go ahead.
Oh, jeez.
Have you ever had a nausea-trois with another woman?
No, I have not.
Never.
And we have discussed that already on the program.
I've been asked.
Yeah, she described in detail
the
time she got a phone call and one of her good friends who was no longer a friend after that, Terry.
No, she's no longer a friend.
Wow. Terry got invited to a menage a trois with one of her, what she thought was a friend, and she had to reevaluate because she was apparently terribly offended by that. I don't know why. I don't know why you can't just decline the invitation, Terry, and not be so offended that you got to rule them out as a friend. But she made the offer with her boyfriend or your boyfriend?
Well, some guy that she was dating at the time.
Some guy she was dating. It wasn't technically the quote-unquote boyfriend,
but she was
certainly very active with.
Yes.
And she invited you to join them in a threesome.
Yes. And she was on the other line listening to my response.
Wow. Did she tell you he was on the other line?
She tried to deny that he was on the other line, but I'm like, I know there's some. What do you want?
I know the sound of jizz. Don't try to fool me.
If anybody knows, it's me.
There's somebody on the other line. Oh, no, there's not. Yes, there is. Oh, then what is that background? Oh, somebody just dropped a phone type thing.
What year was this? Can you refresh us on that? Do you recall?
Let's see. Probably back in. In 87, 88.
Wow. So we're
something
going
like
back a grip, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
We're going back 15 years to find the only time Terry's been invited for a menage a trois. She thought it'd be this long a period in between. She might have taken that person up on it, huh?
No.
So that was the time you were married, too, wasn't it?
No, I was divorced in 87.
Wow, you've been divorced a long time.
We've gone over this, too.
I was struggling through the arithmetic in seventh grade, and Terry's getting divorced.
Terry's getting over some menages.
Who would have thought? Jeez.
And now the woman is, she's
now,
somewhere.
When you picked up the phone on that day in question,
right?
Did you immediately get hit with the invitation right off the bat, or did they start it with just a simple "how you doing" type conversation?
How you doing type conversation?
How did they ease you into it? Did they think you'd be totally into it, or what?
She wasn't sure if I'd be totally into it, mm-hmm. but she kind of tried to preface it like, well, you know what?
I'll tell you what. Can you recount in detail as far as acting it out? Instead of telling us how it happened, how about you be her?
Okay.
And I'll be you.
You're going to be me.
And the caller on the line will be the dude who's pretending like he's not there. All right? So let me turn into you for a second.
You want a story to read or something?
Wrong.
It's a tough part to play.
That is
really
wrong.
Give me a story to read.
Oh, my God.
See, man, listen to this. Apparently. No, okay. I'm you and you're her. Now, don't leave anything out. Try to. Do you need a moment?
No.
I'll tell you what. I'll give you a couple seconds.
Okay.
Terry's refreshing her memory. And she's recalling the day that she sat in her kitchen and passed out because of a weird request that she deemed was weird, of course, by a supposed friend. Sir, you still there? Sir?
Oh, see, he can't be the guy on the other line.
Too bad he was really into it, too.
Trying to be real quiet.
He's playing the part. He's in character right now,
okay.
Terry.
Right.
He's
I'm
not
fondling.
He's not there. He's fondling himself.
Okay,
I'm you, and you're in cahoots with this guy in the line, Terry.
Okay.
All right?
All right.
Go ahead. Okay. Hello?
Hey, girl, what's going on?
Well, I have six guys over right now.
That's not what happened?
What were you doing?
I was actually, I was just really not doing much.
Hmm?
Wait, I mean...
I believe that.
I was
just hanging
probably,
out.
I think it was my day off or something like that.
So we're back
actually,
in...
It might have been.
Well, okay, we're back in 1987.
Say about 88.
All right.
88-ish.
Let's play a song from around that time so we can get in the mode, all right?
All right.
Jeez. Okay, maybe it's a little early, but that's all I can do, all right?
Okay. This is like 78, but we're in 88.
78?
This is 78.
Hall & Oates?
Yeah, 77 about.
Yeah.
This is Hall & Oates, but this is like the earliest Hall & Oates. This is 78.
Yeah.
Terry was 8 years behind. She was in Eastern Washington, right?
Terry's on a 10-year delay. All right. I picked up the phone.
Yep.
Hello?
Hey, girl, what's going on?
Is that how...
yeah, that's exactly how it went.
Okay. I'm doing great, and don't call me girl. That's not what you said?
No.
Okay, go
ahead. I'm like, how are you?
Yes.
Do you want me to write you out a script?
No, no, no. I'll just go how I feel it should be reacted to.
See, well, then...
Go ahead, go ahead.
Hey, girl, what's going on?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So what are you doing?
Actually, nothing.
So you got any plans for, like, tonight or tomorrow? Just stop. See, you got this guy back.
Who's that on the other line?
Nobody.
I'm sorry, I'm still working over the first question. Plans? No, I have no plans.
Oh, no, we've been caught.
Okay, just ask the question. Go ahead.
Well,
asked you for that night?
Yeah.
They didn't give you a week to think about it?
No,
a week
no.
to get prepared?
No, they said either...
A week to trim yourself or anything like that?
They said either... She was...
Now,
she,
back in 88, were women trimming themselves in mass force or what?
Not mass force.
Not mass
Triangle.
Force. Yes.
Into the triangle.
It was the beginnings of the triangle phase.
All right.
Go ahead.
Okay, so she says, you know, my birthday's coming up.
Oh, it was supposed to be a gift that you were going to give her for her birthday.
Yes.
You denied a friend.
Mm-hmm.
How long have you known this woman?
I had probably known her not that long. Just a couple of years.
A couple of years.
I met her prior.
Are you living in Seattle or you're in the
Eastern?
I'm
living here.
Okay,
I'm
you're in Seattle.
Here.
You had been in Seattle for how long?
A couple of years.
Okay, and you met her since you had moved to Seattle.
Yep.
All right.
And we became fairly good friends.
Did you ever have that glance that you both knew that you were attracted to each other?
No. No.
Did you ever sense that she was sizing you up in the 2 years like she was, at the time maybe you hadn't, but now looking back...
Do you ever remember a moment where you thought maybe she was recognizing how into you she was?
Maybe looking back, I could probably say, well, you know, we spent a lot of time together.
Wow.
And she,
would you classify her as a bisexual woman?
I would just say, not necessarily say bisexual, but very adventurous and open for everything.
But she liked guys.
Yes.
She was into penis.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Are you taking this all in, caller?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. We're done with the acting thing. It wasn't really happening.
He's loving it, though.
Right.
All right. Like, so you don't have to be quiet now.
Good question.
All right. So anyway,
she's, you know, trying to kind of build me up. You know, what are we going to do, you know, this weekend or you know.
And you were happy.
Birthday. I'm like, hey, you know, I haven't got any plans yet. What do you want to do? So on and so forth.
Mm-hmm. You commonly went out with her to clubs.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to hook up the wagon there.
Well, yeah. Yeah.
She was sizing you up.
Wow.
We went out quite
often.
You
ever dirty dance with her? It was a big dirty dancing time in 88.
No. Mm-mm.
You didn't make her
all fuzzy bumping?
She didn't ask you to be her Patrick Swayze?
No. Mm-mm.
Does she have a furry butt crack?
No. No.
You don't know. All right. So she,
anyway.
Then she pops the question.
Yeah, so then I'm like, you know, and I am asking, is there somebody on the other line? What do you, why are you, you know, what's taking you so long to, what do you want, you know? Because I get the feeling she's trying to ask me something that she's not real comfortable asking me.
Oh. This is probably on TV. I'm sure Terry was watching this show.
She's still working hard to find an 88 song, Terry.
This 88.
I got one.
Whatever happened to predictability? Okay, I don't know what that is.
I don't either.
Anyway,
we got
Full
House.
Yes. Go ahead.
So anyway, and I'm like, she's hesitating a lot, and I say, well, what do you want? Just ask me whatever you're gonna ask
me. She was beating around quote unquote bush, Terry.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And I don't like that. Just come out and ask me whatever you need to ask me.
Yes.
I'm okay with that.
You told her I don't like you beating around the bush.
Yeah, because she was that you could have. She had a few nervous laughs and things like that. So I said,
she was scared herself to even ask the question.
Yeah, because I
she may be
she
adventurous,
knew,
but she was scared.
She knew probably what my reaction was going to
Did
be.
Did you yell at her?
No, I was like at first pretty shocked. I'm like, you want a what?
Okay, so you get shocked. You say no.
Yeah.
How soon after does the friendship end? Do you ever hang out again after that? Yes or no?
No. As a matter of fact. I mean, we called. She called me.
Stephen, play your song.
And then,
yeah.
A Beastie Boys, always fun.
All right. I mean, we would communicate by phone, but I was like, finally, like after one or two phone calls after that, I said, you know, I'm really not comfortable with hanging out with you anymore because of the request.
Wow. So. Now, do you think now looking back, was that an overreaction or no?
For me? No.
Yes.
No.
Looking back at it now, here we are in 2002. You're months away from walking down the sand. Are you recognizing that that was an overreaction?
No,
that
not
you
for
might
me.
Have been overly offended by the request. You could have simply declined the invitation and still remained a friend.
No, I don't think so. I don't think so.
Caller dropped off.
Oh, dang. Mm-hmm.
Now we can't go any further with this.
He was finished.
Yeah, he's done.
He's done. He got what he needed. So.
Well, I say that you overreacted. I say that there's no reason you should have got as bent out of shape. Maybe in 88 is a different time as far as threesomes. Fine.
Well, but I didn't
there's
know
there's no reason
in the
why
past.
You can't respectfully say no. That's not something that really interests me.
Right.
But call me up next weekend. And we'll hang out.
But
no
you
reason
you had
to terminate your friendship right there because of that request.
But it made me uncomfortable, and I didn't want to be hanging out with somebody who, you know, was going to keep making pressuring me to, you know, who
she
may
you
attempt.
Once. She asked you once. She wasn't going to ask you again.
You don't know that, and I didn't know that, and so I wasn't
I know that!
But if it freaks her out, I mean,
it
she doesn't
did.
Want to be around
kind
her.
Of just, it made me uncomfortable.
Did she make it very clear that she would want to be intimate with you if the threesome happened?
Yes.
She made that clear in the phone call?
Oh, yes.
Cool.
Yeah, because further into the phone conversation, she said, well, what I want to do is, you know, have a threesome with you, but and have this guy I'm dating.
Yes.
Have him watch.
Wow.
Where it's mostly just me and you.
Yeah.
And that's what
See,
I want
if
for
I
my
was there,
birthday.
I'd have
been like, and I was
like,
you are crazy.
You're lucky you didn't know me then.
Yeah.
All right, 1-866-663-T-MAN. Yes, it's not a let's get personal moment, but we continue taking your phone calls.
Have you ever been asked that question?
No.
Me either.
Have you ever tried to set it
never
up?
Never happens to us.
No. Never try to set it up. As a matter of fact, I'm not the big threesome guy. I like one woman at a time.
Right. Okay.
bam, focus all my concentration on her, and still leave her underwhelmed.
Would it be kind of...
You can't go to two until you master one. That's my philosophy.
Yeah, but you don't have to master either of them.
If you're with two?
Yes.
Something tells me, if you can't master one, you're not going to be any better with two. Even though you don't, yes, technically, they don't have to be as serviced as perhaps you would if you were with one. Mm-hmm. Still, there has to be some ability.
Well, you have a partner, see, that's the thing. It's always two on one, so you have help. I'm not talking about experience, because no one's ever asked me that question.
I'm telling you, it's not necessarily my style, believe it or not, but I wouldn't be offended by anyone who asked me. As a matter of fact, I'm taking invitations right now.
But if it came, would you be okay if, like, all of a sudden you went home and your girlfriend said... No, your girlfriend said, guess what, honey? Here's a big fantasy of mine. Can we have a threesome?
If it was a fantasy of hers, I would have to make it happen.
Unless Kilbreath walks in a speedo, I'm ready.
That's not going to happen.
The T-Man.
I'll kick you in the nuts, and we'll call it a day.
The T-Man Show.
Hey, is your husband turned into a lazy-ass bitch? Then call us now. 1-866-663-T-Man.
All right, we knew there was going to be trouble when T-Man said he was going down to Tijuana. We told him don't drink the water, but I think he did. So that's why he's still in Mexico, probably holed up in some, little place where people like the T-Man go. But he'll be back tomorrow. Now more of the best of T-Man.
Yes.
Yeah, I was just in the shower, and my boyfriend was taking...
Stop there a second. You were just in the shower?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
I turn around and look, and my boyfriend's taking pictures of me without my permission.
Mm-hmm. That carries a 4-year sentence, right, Terry? Isn't that the way it is these days?
That's what I'm saying.
And well, where is he now?
He's in the other room.
He's in the other room?
But it's one of those...
Well, make it very clear to him ahead of time, with us as witnesses, that you will press charges if those pictures show up on the internet at any time.
That's what I'm talking about. It's one of those cameras that you can put on the
internet. Then if he does put them on the internet, we'll pretend like we never heard a thing.
He's already had one of those films of me and showed his friends and stuff.
They have actual, like, out-and-out films of you, not just still pictures, huh?
Okay, one film.
Okay, one.
How long have you and him been together? About a couple of hours?
Yeah. No. On and off for like 4 years.
On and off. Has it been more off than on or what?
I don't know.
Yes. Well, do you obviously have a little bit of you inside that gets flattered that he wants to take so many new pictures of you, or no?
No.
Why?
No more. I'm done with that.
You're lying.
Cool.
You're lying. You're done with that? When you were young, you needed the money? What?
No, it wasn't for money.
If you say there's not a part of you that is a little bit flattered that he wants to take so many new pictures of you because your body is so great and that's what inspires him, well, then you're lying. At least give me that. Admit that. Be honest with me, and then I'll help you.
Now I'm afraid that he'll show people.
You're sitting there dripping on the rug, and I'm not saying you don't feel that way as well, but at least give me that there's a small part of you that gets turned on and is flattered by the fact that he loves taking pictures of you.
No, he annoys me.
You lie to me, and I'm not going to help you. As a matter of fact, I'm going to assist him. I'm going to assist him, Terry. I'm going to get all these pictures all over the web as wallpapered as possible.
I want you to tell him I can press charges on him.
Okay, put him on.
Yeah, this ought to be good.
You'll need to see the evidence.
Yeah.
Hello?
Dude, send us the pictures right now. Send me some DVDs. Does that sound like a deal?
Huh?
Can you send me some of those pictures through email right now?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Do that. What does she look like? She hot?
She's all right.
Nice.
Do you have others? Nice. Do you have others that are better?
Huh?
Do you have others that are better?
No.
She's the best one right now.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. How many pictures of her did you get in the shower then?
Huh?
How many pictures of her did you snap while she was in the shower?
I didn't even take no pictures.
Oh, so
man.
She's lying. She's basically smearing your good name by suggesting that you're some kind of whatever women might be thinking that as far as this action's concerned, when you didn't even do that.
Exactly.
Tell her you'll sue her for defamation of character if she continues to call us and say these bogus stories.
There you go.
Well, tell her. What do you mean, there I go? You tell her.
I'm about to sue you.
Why are you
out? Whatever. Look, hold up.
I think a good beating is warranted here,
would
Terry.
Would you stop?
Take pictures of that.
Did you tell her that she's lying and that you'll go develop that film and show her that no pictures were taken? And
yes.
if you do that and she's proven wrong, she has to be your slave for the next 6 months? Make that deal.
Yeah, that's going to work.
Tell her.
She ain't going to go for that.
Put her in her place, man. She's lying about you. Tell her you don't like to be lied about.
Yeah, last time I tried to do that, though, she called the cops on me and tried to have me thrown in jail for it.
Okay. Oh. You can't say those words on the radio, dude. But I understand your frustration there.
Okay.
Now, why don't you put her on the phone? If you can't say it to her, I'll say it to her myself.
All right, hold on. Hello.
I'm glad you picked up the phone again, because I would like to send Pasty Dave the Virgin down to your house. And if you let him take pictures of you, we'll send you some DVDs. How about that?
What a deal.
No.
Why are you lying about this man on the radio? Do you guys realize you can't say the F word on the radio?
I don't care.
Oh, well, that's
you don't
nice.
Care about much these days, do you? You don't care if you lie about this guy?
I'm not lying.
Well, then somebody's got to be wrong.
I want to say hi to all my
I'll
friends.
I'll tell you
and
what.
Haters out there.
Why don't you get those
hi, haters?
Why don't you get those pictures developed? And if you're proven wrong, well, then you got to.
Why would I want to get them developed?
Because you want to find out if he actually did take pictures of you, right?
You can look back on it. It's one
oh, you
of
can?
The
he says the digital camera.
It's a digital one.
Well, look back.
Shut up. You ain't plugging nothing in the computer.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, boy.
Or anything else, anywhere else for that matter. Yeah. Why don't you look back on his camera then and see if he has any pictures of you?
He won't let me see it.
You want to see?
I want to
yeah,
see.
Yeah. I did not.
See, but, what's that right there?
Oh, so you're telling me it's naked?
I'm not wearing clothes. I don't care. You still ain't a
hit her! Hit her! Hit her! Hit her!
Don't.
You're wrong, dude.
It sounds like they have a healthy relationship. Yeah. No big deal here.
Oh, isn't love great?
Doesn't Dr. Phil say that too? Hit her! Hit her! So what's going to happen with the rest of the day with you guys, huh?
More arguing.
Really?
Wow.
Want me to come over?
Why?
I don't know.
You like these guys.
Yeah, you guys sound like you'd have more fun than I will today.
Sounds like fun stuff's happening over there all the time.
It's how well? Only fun the first few months or the first year.
That's all a relationship is fun for?
Yeah, then I'm saying the arguing after that is very frustrating, and I just want to pull my hair out.
Go ahead.
No. Bring some down.
Mm-hmm.
Take pictures of it.
Yes.
Whatever.
All right, is that all?
You tell
her. Get her story straight.
Only three curses per customer.
Thank you.
But thank you for the call.
Wow. Okay.
I did say anything goes today, Terry.
Just like, you did.
But when is it not that way? Anything you want to talk about is fair game. Is someone taking naked pictures of you without your consent? Call now.
Right.
1-866-663-T-MAN. And actually, Stephen Kilbreath.
Yes.
During the break, Terry had a very fascinating idea. He's obviously unwilling to let this menage a trois story go so quickly.
Oh, jeez.
Because he emailed Jimmy Fred Weeman during the break and made a suggestion that we track down this woman who offered you the situation of 1988.
God.
Only for the sole purpose to find out if she, I don't know. I was trying to be nice to Terry. I can't,
right. Can't even go there. The last thing that I know about her really is that she's somewhere in Atlanta. At one time, she was married to some Seahawk. And
she was married to a Seahawk?
Yeah. Wow.
She's probably pretty hot. She probably should have taken that offer, Terry. May have discovered a whole new world. You may be a completely different person if you would have discovered what there was to discover on that night.
Oh, well. Such is life.
Well, I'll tell you this.
What?
Make me a deal.
Make you a deal for what?
That if we're able to find this woman, you say she's in Atlanta, and you probably said that thinking that we won't be able to track her down. If you give us her first and last name, that's all we ask. Write us down, and if we find this woman, you have to finally, after all these years, go through with the menage.
No way. You have got to be crazy. No. No, no, no. It's not going to happen.
I think, Terry,
there's no deal.
You'll
here.
Never be a complete woman.
Fine.
Deep in your heart
so
of hearts.
So let me be incomplete. I am fine with being incomplete.
She may not want to do it either.
Do it for the show, Terry.
No, are you crazy?
Take one for the team.
No, I think I've taken plenty for the team.
Really? I don't think you've taken really any for the team.
Oh, my gosh. Well, come on.
Let me take one for the team. When was the last time you took one for the team?
I've been sitting here taking one for the team for the last 7 years.
Ow!
Well, that's just making fun of you, though.
Terry, how about this? How about this?
Oh, quit wheeling and dealing. That's not going to happen.
No. Last wheel and deal. We can track her down and before the show ends this morning, if we could have her on the line, okay? And you know we don't know her.
Right.
You know that we haven't, like, pre-planned this because we don't know her name or anything right now.
Right.
If we could find her before the end of the show, we'll just shut everything down and just do nothing but try to find her. But if we find her before the end of the show, you have to have some kind of menage.
No. No.
Terry, we're not going to be able to find her that quick. At least give us some...
I'm not giving you anything.
We like some action. It gets our blood pumping. Oh, give us a shot.
What's the damn mouse's name?
Fievel.
Terry?
No.
Come on.
No.
Take a little risk in your life.
Oh, my gosh. No.
You can include that fiance of yours.
No way.
Well, she won't be able to touch him. We'll tell her that.
She's not going to be touching me either.
You're afraid she's going to steal him from you?
Way harder than Terry.
Ah! Ha! Oh. Lies a woman with an invitation for a threesome. You're on the air. Hello?
Can you stop playing that song?
What can we do for you? I can't stop once I start. You can't stop Fievel in the middle.
It's best to just let him finish.
All right.
Anyways, I wanted to tell you threesomes are not that bad.
No one ever said they were.
Right.
I lost my virginity in a threesome.
Wow. How many people could actually say that?
None.
She's a special person there.
They're actually really fun.
Well, T-Man, I lost my virginity in a gangbang.
Yeah.
All right. Mm-hmm. You lost your virginity in a threesome.
Yes.
Two guys?
No, a guy and a girl.
Really?
Yes.
You told me you had never had sex in your life and you had a guy and a girl in one night?
Yes.
How does that happen?
In the same room.
It was really fun.
Huh? And since then?
Oh, I haven't even seen them, so.
I know, but do you have threesomes often or what?
No.
Just that one time?
Yeah.
They were just random people that you ran across, what, in a hardware store or what?
My girlfriend and my boyfriend.
And you never see them anymore. They ran off together, too.
Yeah,
my ex-girlfriend had a baby, and I guess my ex-boyfriend is like some kind of crazy guy that went into a mental hospital.
Okay, I guess this one's for him, though. Give us a shot, Terry. What are the odds of us actually finding her? Nil. In less than an hour?
She should just take the deal.
Take the deal!
You guys won't even find her.
I'll tell you this, and if we don't find her, then Terry Free has a Terry Free Day coming up.
Oh, yeah, right!
What does that mean?
I don't know, but she can decide what Terry Free Day means. give us the less than the hour that we have left to find her, and if we don't find her, which the odds are very strongly in your favor, the Terry Free Day comes up soon.
All stories, all day.
Yeah. All Terry Free games.
I have to read stories. and you have to tell me when and when not to read them. And you have to make fun of me on how I read them.
Do you have to read them fluently or no? Is that not part of the deal?
It's a Terry Free Day.
Okay, so no.
Terry makes the rules on Terry Free Day.
All right.
Terry, I'm giving you a great offer.
Come
on. I'm giving you a wide open check here. I'm giving you a signed blank check.
I know.
Terry Free Day could be whatever you want it to be. You can invite down your... posse?
How about we broadcast live from our house?
Yeah. There you go.
From her bed.
You call the shots on that day. This is the day you've been waiting for, Terry.
And what's to say she wants to still do it?
What was that, Steven?
What's to say that the woman still wants to do it, too, so she may say no.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Terry, maybe she's totally past that stage of her life. Yeah,
maybe she's not into you anymore, Terry.
Terry,
not as hot as you used to be.
On the Terry Free Day, you could fire Jimmy Fred Weeman.
God, that's... Ooh.
Yeah, when does that happen? Yeah.
Terry, you know what Terry's doing? She's stalling, so we have less time to find this woman.
Yeah, she's smart.
You have to make a decision right now.
I don't hear the clock.
Give her 30 seconds, yeah.
Oh! I already gave you my decision, okay? So, that's just been fine.
What's your decision?
I said no.
How do you turn down a Terry Free Day?
No.
Sounds good to me.
We find her.
Whatever.
We can find her. And we can find her in this short time.
Somebody out there knows her.
Somebody out there knows her too, yeah.
Somewhere out there.
Call the Seahawks PR staff.
Right.
He doesn't. He played with this. Is he a well-known Seahawk? Tell us who the Seahawk is.
Tell you who the Seahawk is?
Yes.
It was way back then.
Randall Moss?
No, no.
Steve Largent?
No.
Jim Zorn?
He played with him, though.
Hold on, let me play this one for him. He played with Jim Zorn?
No.
With Steve Largent? Largent. Mm-hmm. Is he a governor, too?
No. Oh, God.
Or a senator, whatever Largent is. Who was he? You don't want to tell us that either?
Well, that'd be too much information.
You think?
Why are you reluctant to tell us
Come
that?
On, just give us the initials.
Give us his initials.
You guys are so childish.
I believe you're... we're not childish. We're offering you Terry Free Day. That's as grown up as it gets.
And her name is Judy Thomas.
You want his initials?
Yes, please.
Oh, jeez. Do you want his position?
Oh, from Herrera.
Thought you didn't do anything with him, Terry.
Yeah, right. How do you know?
Mm-hmm. His initials, please.
T.
Media Guide! T.
Is the first initial.
Yes. Yes.
Is it TT?
No.
Who's TT?
Terry Taylor.
Todd something.
Todd Tombstone?
No. B.
TB? Tuberculosis?
Yeah.
TB! On it! See, now we don't have to make the deal with Terry. We can find this woman.
You don't know her first name.
When we find out who the Seahawk is, we'll have listeners figure it out with us.
Oh, Terry,
you're going to be having a menage by Friday.
I am not having a menage. You know what? You can have a menage with her if she's still down for it, I'm sure.
How far behind are we, by the way? Are we far behind? You're on the air.
Yeah, I don't even know why you bother with her anyway. She's just going to welch out on her bed if she loses. And then, second of all, I don't know why she doesn't get with a girl in the first place, since every time she reads her stories about some dude that did something wrong, all her issues come out and she starts being the scorned woman again.
I think I agree with him.
You're on the air. Hello?
Hello?
Yes. Why am I playing that song? Go ahead.
It's good.
Are you talking to me?
Oh, I forgot. Yes, go ahead. I'm talking to you.
This is Terry's friend, Chris.
You're her friend?
Hi.
Hi, Terry.
Oh,
how
good. Sell out Terry, because you know
she
what?
Would never
Terry
do
will
it.
Drop you in a heartbeat if you do anything out of line.
This
is the Chris that Terry was calling a bitch earlier, I think. I think it's the same one.
Yeah, are you the Chris that Terry called the hoochie and you've screwed every guy that the Western Hemisphere has to offer, or what?
I doubt it.
Mm-hmm. I think you are.
I'm her married friend that she wants to sleep with her husband.
Wants to what?
Remember.
You want to sleep with her husband?
No. Don't you remember that? You called me once.
I don't remember what I had for breakfast
over the
this
years,
morning.
Yeah.
He doesn't remember. Ago.
Who wanted to sleep with her husband?
Yeah.
She was actually, this is my friend Chris, who I've known since I was six.
Do you know the lady or not?
I don't need all these blasts from the past. Right.
Okay.
Do you want to do her or not?
No.
Are you going to tell us who this woman is? Do you know who this woman is?
No, I don't know who the woman is.
All right, thanks a lot. Goodbye.
Was she going to give us something?
Maybe. I'd rather hear Feifel. That woman's annoying voice. You call her friend?
She is.
That says a lot about you.
Since I was six.
There'll be no Terry Free Day. Yeah, you know we will. Mm-hmm. All right, Terry, the offer's off the table.
Fine.
Off the table.
Sounds good to me.
Never to return.
Is it good enough?
Don't beg me for it now, Terry.
I don't think I'm begging.
Huh? Unbelievable. The denial women are able to just profess that they are truly not feeling. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. You can sit there with a straight face with a smile and pretend you're not even curious. You're not even menage curious.
No.
You won't even give me that there was part of you that even though you sat there on the phone acting like you were all bent out of shape as to this offer and you never talked to this supposed friend ever again,
mm-hmm.
You're not going to give me that there was part of you that envisioned what it would be like and was turned on a little bit by it, will you?
No.
Will you?
No.
Because it didn't exist?
It didn't exist.
Liar!
Oh, jeez.
Steven, is she a liar?
I'm not sure if she... I don't
liar!
Think...
Liar!
Look, the burning bush is speaking, okay?
Yes, and it just put your pants on fire.
The T-Man.
Hey, Fred Weeman, you're fired.
Mm-hmm. Big contributor to today's show.
Yes.
Welcome back. Oh, you've been back for about an hour. I just haven't acknowledged you.
Yeah.
Mofo is here. How you feeling there, sir?
I'm doing good.
Yeah? You want to keep that 40B bra as a memento of the morning? You want me to have us all sign it? Makes it go up in value immensely?
But on eBay. That's okay.
You don't even want it?
No.
Wow. You don't want to take it out there and go around the area and see who fits into it like a glass slipper and you'll know then and only then that she's the one for you?
If it wasn't a 40, maybe then... Yeah.
Give me a celebrity. Is there anybody out there that we know of in the world that would be able to fit into the 40B bra?
I have no idea.
Rosie O'Donnell?
Maybe.
Is that 40B? Is that a 40B situation happening there or what?
She might be bigger than B just on default, you know.
Cameron Manheim.
On default?
Just for being 300 pounds, you're bigger than a B.
Yeah. Right.
You just have to be.
Cameron Manheim, I think she's a little bit bigger.
Yeah,
around.
Definitely bigger than a B.
Well, I'll tell you what, then maybe we'll...
I don't know.
Maybe we'll use it as our glass slipper.
Oh, jeez.
Maybe the first woman who could come down here tomorrow morning and fit into the 40B bra will give you night out with Mofo.
Good.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, they'll be lining up tomorrow when we get
here.
Well, how do you want to do this last half hour, Terry? We had a caller that was very into the prospect of playing Let's Get Personal.
Yes.
You know how on edge that puts us all.
Gee, my favorite game.
You want to do that?
Oh, man. I already did mine.
No.
So you're good for today?
I'm good for today.
Terry, if we play Let's Get Personal, we all play Let's Get Personal. This is the opportunity for the listeners to ask us questions and find out in further depth the ins and outs of who we are after being on in this area for 7 years. But, and unfortunately a lot of them can't call at this time because we're playing at different times, there are a lot of new cities that don't know anything.
Right.
I think my mic is shorting out.
Wait a minute.
Gotcha. Yeah, it doesn't matter
with
you.
Best thing for you is no one ever asks you a question.
Not
until
a
now.
Damn thing.
Remember, no one ever asked Hotshot a question.
Last
call
time
now.
We played, nobody asked Hotshot a damn thing.
Nothing.
Ever.
Zero. Come on, let's get personal with Hotshot. Let's just call it that.
The only reason I like this game is that everyone gets so nervous.
I know.
And I can't deny, even I get nervous. I don't know why.
Maybe someday in the future we'll play Dump Free, Let's Get Personal.
Right. We are on the 7-second delay. And Terry Free gives me that look like she wants me to dump something when they ask our very sexual question. This is a Terry Free, Dump Free.
Oh, jeez.
Let's Get Personal.
Wait, well, so
we have any, do we have any good Let's Get Personal theme music?
What are you looking for?
I want something really creepy, like Halloween-y sounding. You
that
have a
I
lot of
Halloween.
Yeah, we have a lot of Halloween music right now, right?
Halloween-y?
Mm-hmm. T-Man's Compressional, you have a Halloween-y? Yeah, that's good right there.
Ooh.
Let's start it over. Okay, yeah, it's a good intro here.
Oh, you've got it all set.
You ready? We're about to play the T-Man's Let's Get Personal. 1-866-663-T-MAN. We will answer any question you have. The only thing that enables you to make your question valid is by doing it in the proper format. You will address the person that you would like to ask the question to. You will pause, wait for them to acknowledge you. And then you will ask your question. For instance, Stephen Kilbreath.
Yes.
Let's get personal.
I'd love to.
Yeah, Halloweeny.
I do.
You can ask a question of Stephen Kilbreath.
You
can ask a question of Hot Shot Scott.
Never.
You can ask a question of Cherry Free.
Always.
You can ask a question of Mofo.
Ooh.
Good one.
The real Mofo.
Yeah.
Let's get personal. Let's make sure he understands the format. The real Mofo?
Yes.
Let's get personal.
All right, let's do it.
He's all gung-ho.
Okay, here we go.
You forgot someone on your list,
and
by the way.
Yeah, by the way.
Oh, who? Everyone knows that.
All right, okay. Oh, do they?
And the best part about this, ladies and gentlemen, you will just hear your phone ringing, and then all of a sudden you'll be on the air. That's the interesting part about it. There is no call screening.
Right.
There's no nothing.
Really?
No, nothing.
Yeah.
No.
It's
gonna ruin
sure
my weekend.
You're on the air,
Mr. T-Man.
Yes.
Does your Let's Get
Personal? Sorry, I didn't do it right.
Got it. God, so close, dude. So close.
That would have been a really troubling question for me. You got to say, you got to address the person that you are waiting to ask the question of, and then you got to wait for them to acknowledge, and then you got to say, let's get a personal.
Right.
Oh, jeez.
You're on the air.
Good try, though.
I don't like this music, by the way.
Win!
That was easy enough.
Yeah, that was.
That was Scott's question.
Maybe this will be an easy run of let's get personal. You're on the air.
Hot shot, Scott.
Yes.
Let's get personal.
Go ahead. Format has been laid out.
Besides the time when you took a roofie on the air, have you ever been stoned while on the job?
This job?
Well, I know you worked at the Spaghetti Factory. I'm sure you had to be, but yeah, that job.
This job, besides the roofie, I have not been.
Okay, thank you.
Really? It's too early, man. I've learned something new about you today. Well, I just act like it at the time. No, it's too early.
It hasn't even carried over from the night before or something?
Come on.
That's probably one thing, but yeah. No, I'm not blazing at 5 a.m. So you've never done anything after you've woken up. That's what you're saying. But you could have still been left over from the night before.
I've definitely drank on the job, but, you know, we've been out at functions and stuff.
Right.
But no.
All right.
That was so damn simple.
Hot Johnson!
Yeah.
You're on the air.
Fred Wayman.
No, Fred Wayman's not involved.
Come
because
on.
Then
why can't he
because
be involved?
I'll tell you why. Because if we make him involved, then everyone's going to call up and say, why don't you let me on the air when I call?
Right.
No, this one is not going to be like that, I promise.
I don't give a crap. He's out. I don't want to know anything about him anyway.
Yeah, that's true.
I like it how it is.
Find different music here singing.
Okay.
This is better. It makes us more nervous hearing the music better.
On the air.
Steven.
That's wrong format.
She said your name.
She didn't say Stephen Kilbrass.
Supposed to say yes.
Oh, my God.
Okay, yes.
Let's get personal.
Okay.
Let's get nitpicky.
Ever had a threesome?
No.
not even with your wife, that Amy, was, and anyone else?
That was an easy question. No.
Oh, come on. Boring.
It's very boring, and I'm proud to be boring.
Yeah, during this game, especially.
I'm a proud, boring guy.
You've never been more proud in your life than this game. You're out of the air.
Hot shot, Scott.
Yes.
That's it, personal.
All right.
Hey, what happened between you and her girl that prevented you from coming up to Alaska?
Well, it just didn't work out. She ended up going to a funeral in Alaska, and so she kind of took too much time off work, and we couldn't do it. And no, I've never had a threesome.
Okay. You're out of the air.
Terry Free.
Yes.
Let's get personal.
Let's do.
What is it like working with a 5'3" Freddie Wee?
It's painful every morning.
Thank you.
Oh, it's getting lame. These questions are easy. You're out of the air.
Hey, guys, let's get personal.
Who?
Everybody.
That can't happen that
way. No, got to be individual.
One per customer, man.
You guys have had a big morning show, Orton. Yeah. You're out of the air.
Oh, we have done that.
Hello?
Yes.
Oh, great burning bush.
Yes, my child.
Let's get personal.
Fine.
Why do we never hear you laugh?
I'm not a laugher.
All we ever hear is...
That's his laugh.
That's
it.
Laugh.
That's what
I
it
guess
is.
I am a laugher. When I laugh like that, that's how I laugh a lot of times.
Dorky.
I don't think I don't think we're very funny.
We always hear Terry Free. She's got a very...
Yeah, I've heard her from time to time, yes. I can't help you. That's the best I can give you, sir.
Say, okey-doke.
The day that there's something funny said around here, you'll hear me laugh.
But even in, like, real... anything, you never really laugh at anything.
I'm sorry. What do you want me to do?
No, it's okay.
We're okay with it.
You're on the air.
Oh, yes.
Let's get personal.
Okay, let's do.
Hey, Terry Free, do you ever watch any pornos get off?
I think he's watching one right now.
Yeah. Do I really have to answer him? Like,
you know, before you have sex, has anybody put on a tape for you or anything like that?
Yes.
Yeah. Honestly, actually.
What is it called? Not like a real porn, but like soft porn thing.
Oh, whatever, Terry. You've never seen XXX movie before you got...
No.
Oh, jeez.
A soft porn thing.
All right, a soft porn thing, sir, is her answer.
Not even the how do I measure up video?
No. You're an A.
You're on the air.
Now we know she's lying.
Hey, T-Man.
Yes.
T-Man, let's get personal.
Sure, sir.
Question for you.
Huh?
Have you ever thought about banging Terry Free?
I have, yes, but I think about banging everyone I see that's a female. But that's remotely attractive, and Terry would fall under the heading of remotely attractive. However, it's never been anything that I've masturbated over or anything like that.
Really?
Oh, come on, man.
Stop. Or not in the past year.
You ripped one out over Terry Free, man.
Maybe
come
I
on.
Have. Maybe I rubbed one out about 3 years ago. Yeah, I think I did.
Great.
I don't think I could. I think I might have, actually.
Mm-hmm. People are fascinated right? with you, too.
Has he ever...
No!
Oh,
well,
one customer.
Hot Shot was quick on
now, does that change the whole working relationship, Terry? If I can't say for sure. I've done so many different women. I need variety in my life.
I'm sure you
safe
do.
To say you pretty much mashed it over everybody in the office at least once, right? I mean,
you just do. Everyone in the office.
Okay, top 10 in the office.
Oh, definitely top 10 in the right. office. And the top 10 is not anything to be proud of. All right. All right, there's today's installment.
There
we got to do it next time with more time.
No,
it's so much fun. Oh, let me laugh.
The T-Man.
Okay, that does it. Screw you guys, I'm going home.
You've been listening to the T-Man Show with Terry Free, Hotshot Scott, Jimmy Fred Weeman, Pasty Dave. We thank you for listening today. As you know, today was a best-of program, and we sure hope you enjoyed it. How could you not when Mofo is unhooking people's bras? It's brilliant. Brilliant. Brilliant, I tell you. T-Man is still recovering from his Super Bowl party, and we'll be back tomorrow with us. Hope you have a great day.